There it is. Let's go. Man, this song hits like nostalgia. So hopefully I got everything working. Sweet music, yes! We're going back. Hello, snooting time. Hey, Sten. Actually, let me set the timer again. We'll give you guys 5 minutes before we start. Back to caveman on with no budget, pretty much. No animations for you guys. Ready to lose my voice. Today almost didn't happen because I was like choking trying to cough up ice cream I swallowed wrong, which is great. But I have my cough drops on hand. I feel like I'm ready. Red Fox Jack, no budget, but back to the OG Snoot. Catching one live today. Yeah, we took like a week off, so everyone should have time to catch up. But hey, cool. How's it going? Hey, Zen. Everyone's gonna be here again. We are so back. For now, Lemon, for now. Outstanding. Maybe it's because Snoot had its updates, but it feels like Snoot had more art compared to Wani. As in unique art for scenes, probably, so that animation budget, it ate up like everything else. That and the music. Alright, so Hinan is going to be attempting to not get drowned into a lake by Ripley. I like the threesome one? What? Hemlo, Gades, and Lentilman. Third time's the charm. I wonder what they will cook next. Yeah, me too. They're probably gonna work on that RPG of theirs. Morning soundtrack is peak. Left before we jump right in. So I think it shouldn't be too long. We could probably reach one ending tonight, I'm hoping. Came back from the gym. That is good. One ending. How long is this? Not familiar with whatever the modders have done. I don't know. I think this one took a year. It's a spinoff from ending 3 or 4. Gotta go to the gym to get stronger. Alright. We're done waiting. There's no more waiting. We're starting. We are starting. Can't be here for long, but wanted to say hi. Well, hello, Crimson. Hope your day is going great. Options. Wait, no, that'd be extras. Mods. Fishing trip. Jumping right in. Thursday afternoon. It's been a few weeks since I had that date with Fang. Speaking of Fang, she said she had some stuff to take care of. So I'm on my own tonight, and I need to learn how to fucking read again. Hold on, let me start with a water break. Read slow and read coherently. I'm looking forward to an enjoyable night of video. Maybe Rock Ring 2? Say it's about two hours to get to the longest ending. Well, maybe that'll be the long haul, because I gotta like read this vocally. I'm looking forward to an enjoyable night. Oh wait, I'm still hesitant on a instead of lasso, it's Laro run. I sit down on my bed and stretch as I boot up my Xrox. Ring ring. Maybe not as alone as I hoped. I check my phone and see an unknown number pop up. It's not Fang, so who could it be? Probably another damn solicitor. Look, lady, whatever you're selling, I'm not buying. Go bother someone else. Try again. I know that voice. I can tell immediately by the way the hairs on the back of my neck stand on end. That gruff voice. People still doing Snoot game mods? Yes, they are. This is the latest one. That gruff voice, the edged tone that wants nothing more than to rip my spine out and bludgeon my body with it. Mr. Aaron, how did you get my number? Lucy. She gave it Lucy's phone. That explains it. I set the Duke down and go grab the phone I have been cradling in the crook of my neck. Listen, I'm setting up a fishing trip. We're going this weekend. Leaving tomorrow afternoon and returning Sunday night. What did this have to do with me? I hope he wasn't alluding to. You're coming with. I have a cabin up on Lake Sulaco. Nazer and Mo will be coming too. Is it Nazer or Nasser? I don't know. I've like adjusted to Nazer. Great. He's planning to drown me. He's even bringing Nazer and Mo as an alibi. I know Mo has ties to the Mafia. I swallow my fears and nod shakily. Not that he can see me through the phone. Can he? Okay, sure. Be at my home after school tomorrow. We're taking my car. I find myself struggling to give a coherent response. Yes, sir. Don't go in on, you'll never come back. And make sure you pack everything you need. We aren't making stops along the way. Will do. Don't sound so meek, Agnon. Good, I expect to see you then. Before I can utter a response, he hangs up. A fishing trip with Fang's dad? This is gonna be a disaster. He already hates me. Mostly, I think. Does he just wanna watch me squirm? I don't even know the first thing about fishing. I'm gonna make an ass of myself, I can tell. I flop backwards on my bed, suddenly exhausted and yet at the same time too awake to sleep. Maybe it's not too late to back out. Do I even have a choice? I hardly slept last night. The idea of spending the weekend with Fang's dad at an isolated cabin kept me on edge. I'd pack a bag full of clothes and one pair of discount swim trunks I never planned to use. I left it on my bed for easy pickup on my way to Fang's house after school. Maybe I should speak to Nazer about the trip beforehand. He can give me some tips or pointers. Be true to yourself, Porku. The nervousness surrounding the afternoon hangs over my head as one class melds into the next. It feels like no time has passed, but suddenly the lunch bell rings. I'm not hungry. My legs unconsciously take me to the men's room. I don't feel like interacting with anybody right now. Nazer was a thought, but if the venue hunt date with Fang was anything to go off of, Nazer would have folded if his dad told him I was going. I head to the sinks and splash some cold water on my face. Gotta clear my head so I can focus on the rest of school. I sigh. I can't keep hiding from my problems like this. Anon, that you, bro? A voice from one of the stalls speaks. I lift my head from my hands. Reed? How'd you know it was me? Sweet, it's just you. I could hear you talking to yourself again. The sound of laughter striking up hits my ears. The smell of skunk soon follows. Reed, I don't think that's a good idea. Besides, don't you just drink carf out of your thermos? I'm actually hiding from Spears, man. I lost the King Rex costume a bit ago and I can't let him see me. What do you mean you lost the costume? How? Reed giggles and snorts as a fresh puff of smoke billows around the stall. Aliens, man. I wait for him to elaborate further, but he stays silent as he takes another audible drag from his bong. Wait a second. I just got an idea. Reed's looking to hide from Spears. I need backup to ensure I don't end up at the bottom of Lake Sulaco in a pair of cement shoes. Hey, Reed. How would you feel about coming on a fishing trip this weekend? You know, to lay low. I guess this takes place before the bowling alley, sort of. Doesn't he store his stuff in his costume? Off. Me? Are you sure, man? I know you and Fang are still spending some alone time together. Actually, this is gonna be a guy's fishing trip. Fang won't be coming. It'll be me, Nazer, Mo, and Fang's dad. Bros weekend? Hell yeah, man. There's another audible puff. Count me in, dude. Good, with Reed there, hopefully it will dissuade Mr. Aaron from hostile acts. One question remains though, do I have Reed meet us at the lake or just meet up at Fang's place? Oh, is this gonna be the first choice, guys? Where's his glass? Bro, he's not that man. Yeah, Howling, you need to go through some Snoot lore here. Let me grab a drink. Alright. If he tails me to Fang's, he can be there to help me persuade Mr. Aaron to let him come with. Or, I could have him meet us at the lake, that way Reed's already there and it'll seem like a coincidence. Yeah, it is the first choice, guys. Where to meet Reed. Well, how would he meet at the lake? Would he already have, like, stuff there? Like, everything, like, the spot paid for. All the necessary things there. Or meet up at Fang's house. I mean, technically, Reed wasn't supposed to be part of the equation, so that could probably go south fast. Bowling. When we find out the reason Ripley goes so hard on Anon, because apparently Sam's dad did it to him. I don't know, I feel like meeting at the lake would be the best one. The least one to go wrong. Ripley knowing versus Ripley not knowing. Huh. I mean, I guess this would be a time to save, good as ever. honesty the best policy, or we wing it? You know what? I'll go with meetup. This is probably the worst decision yet. Bro meetup. Wait, bro meetup. I say at Fang's. It's too late. I already chose. Fang's dad likes Reed anyways, right? No, I don't think he does. I don't think he does. Meet us at Fang's place after school. We can get a chance to talk to Mr. Aaron. 10-4, man. I'll see you there. Oh, by the way, I see his open hand reach out from under the stall. Pass a guy a roll? the classic ding-dong bing-bong. The final bell lets us loose from the confines of our classrooms. For once, I don't want the school day to end. I slowly walk down the halls from the front entrance, feeling as if I'm an inmate on death row, walking to the execution chamber. The sun is still brightly shining in the sky, the heat of late May signaling the end of spring. Even the trip back to Skin Row is shorter than I would have liked, and I stretch... Oh, ooga booga ook ook just subscribed. Oh, thank you. Even the trip back to Skin Row is shorter than I would have liked, and I stretch the walk up the stairs to my apartment as long as I can make it. I grab my bag and continue my walk to Fang's house. I could take the bus, but I want to prolong my final hours on Earth as long as they'll go. Maybe I'm just overreacting. Maybe I could find a way to actually bond with him. Maybe find some common ground. Is it possible that would even work? Could I grow on him? Like a tumor, maybe. Mosquitoes are annoying me while inside my house. That sucks. I think Ripley is okay with Reed, but Samantha isn't. Remember the double date? I don't know if I specifically remember that. It isn't long before I find myself nearing the Aaron household. On cue, I see Reed pull up in his van just as I reach Fang's house. My eyes pan to Fang's dad, who's already out in front with Mo in their bags. Fang's dad doesn't look too happy. As I approach, he eyes me and then Reed again. Reed spreads his arms wide as he exits his van, a huge grin on his face. Mr. Aaron, good to see you. It's been a hot minute, dude. What are you doing here, Reed? It sounds like he already knows the answer. Like, Anon here invited me on the guys' trip you were planning. I can't wait to hang with you dudes. Mr. Aaron's withering gaze of death follows on me as I meekly approach. He did he? I sure would have liked to known about that. Considering I planned the trip and all. Shit, how do I respond? I obviously fucked up. Emotional support, Raptor? I chuckle nervously. What the fuck was that? Emotional support, Raptor? Mr. Aaron's penetrating gaze drills straight through my corny smile and into my soul. Fuck. You won't need to worry too much about me, Mr. Aaron. Reed's relaxed tone cuts through the tension. I have my van to sleep in, and I brought plenty of snackage. It'll be like I'm not even there. Mr. Aaron sighs with exasperation as his hand drags down his face. He waves a hand at us and goes back to his bags, where Mo can't help but chuckle. We leave in 10 minutes. Where's Nazer? Right here, Dad. Got my bags and grabbed extra towels. Should be good to go. Nazer's eyes fall to Reed, who is leaning against his van as he watches the clouds. He spots Nazer and waves. What's Reed doing here? And Anon here invited him along. He'll be fishing with us, looks like. The edge in his voice could cut straight to bone as I gulp down my fear. I can see Nazer approach out of the corner of my eye. Reed would be a great emotional support, Raptor. How are you holding up? I offer a forced smile. Can't wait to go fishing. Where's Fang? I feel like she would at least see me off. I try not to clench my teeth as I speak. She's out shopping with Mom, against her will. Nazer gives me an encouraging pat on the back. Don't worry, it won't be as bad as you think. I'll try my best to keep Dad from killing you. Thanks, Nazer. Big help. I can always count on you. It isn't long before Fang's dad starts up his SUV. Last call, everybody. Wait, last call, everybody finish loading up. We're leaving now. My face falls into my hands as Mo opens the trunk of the car. Well, don't just stand there, Anon. Help us load up. Alright, sorry. I grab my things and toss them into the back before returning to help Mr. Aaron with the rods. I try to handle them as gently as I can, but I feel his watchful eyes on my back. My fear is palpable. Reed gets his things sorted and hops into his own van to follow after us. We get art here. Yeah, I'll let this sit for a bit and take a drink. Oof. Fish and I have entered an uneasy alliance against women. Oof. I love water. Water is tasty. We finish loading up and get into the SUV. It's pretty nice and still has that new car smell too. Mo has claimed shotgun. Realistically, it's the only seat that he can fit in. The fucking Portal song. I wouldn't know. It's been a while since I played Portal. Well, not played, but watched it be played because I'm not a real fan. Nazer and I take the middle row of seats. Unfortunately, I'm stuck behind Mo. He likes to lean his seat back. Mr. Aaron says the drive will take an hour and a half, but every time I peek at the dashboard clock, it seems like time passes slower. I heard a snoot was occurring. Oh, you're right. This is Snoot. And it's awkwardly silent. Mo turns his massive head back to get one of his eyes on me. He smiles wide with a toothy grin. So, Waynon, I heard you's been considering college, that right? I sit up and nod, snapped out of my daydreaming. Fish. Hey, Bacon. Yeah, I think I found some classes involving sound engineering. Sounded like something I could do. Well, then until college starts for you, you'll be needs a job, right? I know where this is going. I've already helped them before. Why not come work for old Mo? I could use an extra set of hands to throw some dough. I guess I could help out here and there. It'd be nice to have a little spending money. I'll need a source of income to stay in my apartment too, considering my lease ends in June. Sounds like a good way to learn responsibility. You'll take the job. Wait, I didn't agree to this yet. Who said he could make decisions for me? My facial expressions must have given away what I was thinking. I could see Ripley staring at me in the rearview mirror. He readjusts it to get a better look at me. I've suddenly lost my will to object. Sounds good. I can't wait to get you started. He'll fits right in. I do what I can to avoid continuing this conversation. I forgot and I'm late. The video will still be around in GP. It'll still be here. So, what's the biggest fish you guys have caught out here? Nazer puffs out his chest. I proudly hold that title. I caught a giant gar a year back. It weighed about 200 pounds and was about 5.5 feet long. He uses his hands to roughly measure out the size of the aquatic predator. Ah, I remember that trip. That was the time you got that fish down your pants, weren't it, Rip? Shut it. They continue on with reminiscing while I gaze out the window. The cityscape gave way to a more rural sprawl about 15 minutes ago. We've passed at least two nameless podunk towns and a handful of gimmicky tourist traps. Where is this place anyway? What about you, Anon? Oh, uh-huh. How often do you go fishing? I haven't. There aren't many bodies of water in Rock Bottom. Just swamps in the local reservoir. Hasn't even crossed my mind since I've been here in Volcadera either. Hey, looks like we're popping his fish cherry tonight then. Ugh. Don't say it like that. Can't be that hard, right? Just cast the line and wait for a nibble. Just cast the line. Not even close. It's much more in depth. Offer a forced laugh at what I thought was an intentional pun. I get it. In depth, like water. Good one. You need patience and skill in order to reel in most fish. Just yoinking on the pole is a good way to rip its jaw off. Yes, sir. I'll keep that in mind. Maybe for you. I'm human, remember? Mr. Hearn's hands shift on the steering wheel. And by the way he looks back at me, it seems like he was going to ask me another question, but decides against it. Besides, the occasional story from trips past, the rest of the ride is quiet. Phrasing. How do you download this mod? It's in Snoot Club. Or it's in the cool 4chan Discord. The Snoot Discord. Snoot Club or Snoot Discord? Or whatever. They posted about it. You can download it from the mega site. Is this the first chapter? Am I in the wrong area? This is a mod, Golden Foxy. This is a whole ass mod. Eventually, we reach the lake. There's a convenient parking for... Well, I might as well just let you guys see that for a bit. There's a convenient parking for hikers, and people with cabins have access to small garages to store their vehicles. Mr. Aaron parks just outside one with the Aaron last name labeled on the garage door. Everybody grab your gear, we'll offload it at the cabin and come back around to the dock. The boat should be moored there. Azer turns his back to me, gesturing to the bags at my feet. Keep up, Anon. We got to grab the rest of the bags. Nazer was only holding a carry-on. Thanks for the help. Holy shit, the weight! What's in these things? Bowling balls? More art. Ripley's bar right there on the left. Ripley's bar. Yeah, freaking jarred hand. What the hell is this guy doing? As we enter the cabin, Mr. Aaron drops his bags off on one of the recliners. Nazer and Mo do the same. With a struggling gasp, I leave the rest of the bags close to the door. Alright, everyone change into your trunks, we're hitting the water. As I wait for my turn to change in the bathroom, I admire the modestly sized yet swanky cabin. It's one story with a ladder giving access to a single pitch roof. Outside is a small fire pit and a couple deck chairs. The cabin's main entrance is a sliding glass door, leading to a cozy living room. Back inside, the smell of aged wood fills my nostrils. To the right of the hallway is leading to what I assume are the bedrooms. On the far wall, there's a few dusty bookshelves. Sitting on one of the shelves is a pickled ham, which we saw before. Now the question is, are the devs referencing to Moldovan folk singer named Solak, or is it reference to something else? I wouldn't know. I'll assume that's a prop. To the left is a pair of doors. One is open to reveal a bathroom, complete with a small shower and a clawfoot tub. The other door is closed, but reads Ripley's Bar on a plaque on the outside. The entire place is well kept, but despite being modern, lacks the typical 21st century amenities, like a TV. No rock ring for you, Anon. Or Wi-Fi. Looks like no shitposting this weekend. Not that I had any cell service anyways. He's gonna die, guys. It's all over. Gravity makes another attempt on my life as my foot catches on the net of the cheapo trunks. Fuck! I fall backwards and nearly bash my head against the toilet seat. At least that one wasn't as bad as the bollard. Everything okay in there, Anon? You fall in? Oh, just practicing karate, kicking my own ass. No shit posting. There he is. New sprites and all. I like Nazer's get up. I finish changing and exit the bathroom to overbearing silence. They're all staring. Maybe I should crack a joke? This feels like a serial killer. This feels like a serial killer's house. More like a stabbing in the woods, huh? Everybody groaned. Except Mr. Aaron. Let's go. We're wasting daylight. Can we waste some more? I follow everyone else back to the lakefront from here. I can see Reed has parked next to Mr. Aaron and set up a hammock close by. Looks like he's already settling in. I see Ripley does own the dad uniform. How the fuck did Reed even beat us here? In that barely street-legal hippie love van anyways. Reed waves over to me and Mr. Aaron as we make our way down to the docks with the others. Mr. Aaron offers a nod back in his direction. Maybe I should try to smooth things over with him. We're gonna get a choice? Mr. Aaron? What? He sounds disgruntled. Off to a bad start. I avoid his gaze and steel my nerves. I wanted to apologize for bringing Reed along uninvited. Casper? Thanks for the sub, Casper. If that's... I don't know how to pronounce that, but thank you. Apart from what you may think, I do enjoy his company. Wait, what? Seems like they both suffer from reefer madness. A cop, though? You do? He's shown he cares for Lucy in a platonic way. The way I like it. His eyes burn through the back of my skull. There's blistering heat on my scalp, and it's not coming from the sun. We got a picture of a boat. What is that? S-H-I-T. It was supposed to be S-Hiddle, and now it just says shit. It's the shit boat. Luckily, we arrive at the boat. Nacer is already in the process of untying it from the dock. It's a decent 30-foot vessel, but it's clearly seen better days. I spy the nameplate as we board. S-Hit. We sleeping with the fishes with this one? Pretty much. Shit. I hear a sigh from Mr. Aaron behind me as both Mo and Nazer burst out laughing. SS Hiddle. There was slight damage to the nameplate. The shitmobile. We're wearing concrete shoes with this one too. The motor sputters and whines as Mr. Aaron keys the ignition. Nazer awkwardly scrambles against the dock, pushing us off with a grunt. Seems like he's well-versed in his dad's fishing itinerary. How long have you had this boat, Mr. Aaron? How old are you, Nazer? Nazer pauses before answering. 18. Why? About 22 years, then. The boat is older than me. Is that a bad thing? When does one usually get rid of a boat? It seems to be moving at one of two speeds, slow and agonizingly slow. I could row faster at this rate. The floating turd. The sun is on its way back down the horizon, but with it being May, we still have a few good hours to enjoy out in the water before nightfall. Apart from us, there is not a single soul on the lake. Where's Reed? And Mo? Mr. Aaron slows the boat to a stop. Looks like this is the spot. He eyes me again before turning back to the rods he brought. He takes one for himself and grabs an additional two. He hands a black and orange rod to Nazer, then turns to me. Hands me a brown one, but holds it in his grip, even as I attempt to pull it away. I'm lending you one of my fishing poles this weekend, Anon. Do not break it. He doesn't need to add the or else after. I can piece two and two together. Yes, sir, I'll take good care of it. Good. With that, he nods to Mo, who flips open one of the tackle boxes he had brought with him. What the hell? What is this? It's like red ketchup paste. Ugh. Inside is a variety of different lures, both live and fake. Mr. Aaron uses a rubber worm and a flashy tail. Mo attaches something similar, and Nazer chooses something with a spiny tail. Reed brought his own homemade bait, and surprisingly doesn't smell like carf. Bait. Yeah, it's probably bait. Bait box. I was expecting like a regular tackle box, though. Let me get a drink. Ooh, ice cream. Red ice cream? You're kidding! Meat paste. Mo brought the meat paste from the pizzeria. Strawberry. They all look at me expectantly. I can fucking talk. I stare back before forcing my body to take a cautious step towards the box. What do I use? There isn't really a difference between all of them, right? The flaccid looking one. The flashy thing. The spinny one. Get the spinny one. You spin me right around, baby. Right round. Put the bait in the miniature. I reach my hand in to grab my lure of choice. As I root around in the box, I can feel my fingers brush one of the barbed hooks. Ouch. I reel my hand back as the others wait impatiently. Without thinking, I nab a glob of rancid-smelling paste before smearing it on the hook. I hear Mo snickering behind me, but I don't bother to look back. Eat. Consume. Honestly, I wouldn't be really comfortable hanging around someone who doesn't like me seems stressful. Yeah, I feel that. Why is this all so embarrassing? It's like all eyes are on me. Wow, look at this piece, guys. Man, Microsoft Paint is a blessing. Mr. Hearn lets out a chuckle of his own and casts his lure. I mimic his hand movements and send the line far into the lake. It's soon joined by Nazer and Moses' line. Don't get the lines tangled, Anon. Wait, why is he only telling me that? Behind me, I can see that Reed has cast his line on the opposite side. The minutes tick by. I crane my head around to check on the others. They're all focused on their bobbers in the water. Fishing with my stepdad, he'd sometimes use stink bait, a mess of cat food looking stuff you'd mold around the hook. Huh. Honestly, I was expecting tiny dead dinos as bait. Imagine catching a megalodon. I turn back. How much longer until I hook a fish? How's school been, son? Good. Track team won another trophy, too. Well done. Mm-hmm. Have you dudes ever hiked up the trail here? It's pretty untamed, man. We saving up the budget with this one. What do you mean? You can find some pretty neat plants when you look hard enough. Like Darlingtona californica. Or the carnivorous herb. Pinguscula macroceras. Literal word salad. We laugh as I roll my eyes. Of course Reed was up here looking for vegetation to get high off of. Every time I went fishing on a boat, there was always more drinking than fishing. I wouldn't doubt that. I think. Did I ever tell you punks about the time I swears I spotted a mermaid out here? It was a carp. Ah, oh, but it had a pretty good looking face. Could have passed for one if you squinted enough. I see Mr. Aaron shake his head out of the corner of my eye. Conversation rises and falls like this at random intervals as we reel and recast. Never fished on a boat, only on shore. I've done it a boat like maybe once or twice. Reed pulls in a bass. I was going to say bass. Yes, Reed is now the bassist. It was meant to be. Everybody else seems to get at least one bite at some point as well. Except for me, right? Except me. Racist fish. As we fish into the evening, the setting sun casts a scenic red and purples across the sky. I can feel a looming presence behind me. Judging by the way my fight or flight senses triggers, I know it's Mr. Aaron. How are you doing, Anon? I don't seem to be popular with Moe's mermaids. Do you know why that is? No, sir. He takes the rod from me and points to the bait I had used. This here is deep sea bait. We're out on a lake right now. You should have used something similar to what we used. I feel annoyed by this revelation. And nobody thought to say anything. The only way you'll learn is through failure. His voice gets a little harder, and that with that, his face is stern. I shrink below his gaze again. So far, so good. I don't think so. I think we made a wrong choice. Maybe I shouldn't have come off as quite so defensive. We are keeping this channel alive with this one. Yes, you've said that before. We're almost... we almost had 50 viewers. Mr. Aaron sighs and sets the rod down as he returns to the tackle box. He pulls out a sparkly rubber worm out and shows it to me. When I was a bit younger than you, my father took me out to this lake. I hadn't known a thing about fishing. He wipes the remainder of the bait from my hook and puts the new lure on. He gave me no pointers, no directions. He put a rod in my hands and said, "Catch a fish." We spent 9 hours out here. I didn't catch a damn thing. Like father, like stepson. A small smirk spreads over his beak. I was so frustrated, I threw my rod in the water. Pops grabbed it back out and put on a new lure. Then he used that rod to fish while I sat there and sulked. He caught a fish on the first cast. Is he trying to compare himself to me? He's literally me! I'm lost. This isn't the usual aggression I feel from him. I could see him deflate as the smile disappears from his face. He sighs and digs the key to his boat out of his pocket before handing them to me. See those two buoys out there? I crane my neck around to the front of the boat and spot the two distant buoys bobbing in the water. Yes, sir. I see them. Take the keys and drive us up that way. Didn't type fast enough for the first plant name, but second plant is real. Californian butterworm, native to Pacific coast, leaves sticky, catch, eat insects. Huh. Slowly. The keys to the boat? I never driven a car before, let alone a fucking boat. But I don't know how to... It's not driving, it's piloting. But you just said... You know what I meant. It's not that difficult. So much slapping here, man. Push the lever forward slowly and keep a hand on the wheel. I have to rig the lines for trawling. Be careful, kid. Watch out for logs, stumps, rocks, icebergs, people, other boats, and lake weed. Don't want that weed catching on the propellers. Reed perks up. Lake War? Wait, what? This is something I'm completely inexperienced with. What if I do end up hitting something out here and I capsize the boat? Or worse, what if I hit a person? Maybe I'm overreacting. This hunk of junk doesn't seem to be able to go over 2 miles per hour anyway. But still, I should stand my ground if I feel like I'm not up to the task. Be a man and grow a spine. To drive or not to drive? We gotta take the keys. I was forced to drive too on the boat. And boy, oh boy, I almost crashed. Well, it wasn't almost, but... Let's just say they took the wheel from me before that could happen. So we're gonna drive. We're gonna drive, boys. And I don't want to break the boat like they did in this... What? Step Brothers movie? The game could already be called 50 Shades of Grey for all those slaps. Oh, God. Save. Okay. I'll save again. I'll take the keys. YOLO, I guess. I cautiously step over the captain's chair and look over the immense amount of buttons and gauges. I look back one last time to Mr. Aaron and see he's already got his back turned and is in the process of tying lines. I turn to the controls and key the ignition. The motors sputter and turn over before they finally come to life. I see the needles on a few of the gauges flare. Captain Anon reporting for duty. I tentatively grab the lever and slowly push it forward while maintaining a white-knuckle grip on the wheel with my other hand. Save and drive, be confident. The boat creeps forward at a slow pace and the screen flickers on to my right. It looks to be a crude sonar system by the way the screen ripples and changes as the boat trundles forward. It resembles a shitty retro game. Damn, this isn't actually that bad. It's pretty fun. How's it going, Anon? Pretty good. I thought this would be a lot worse, but it's a cakewalk. Glad to hear it. I'm surprised Dad gave you control. Must mean he trusts you a bit. I have to laugh at that statement. He probably just wants me preoccupied so I don't fuck something else up. Don't know about that one. Don't go selling yourself short, kid. You done good. I nearly jump as the T-Rex appears behind me. Man, this mad really likes its slap noises. You're already doing better than I did when I first got to pilot. I ran the boat around the shallows. Dad wouldn't let me hear the end of it. He laughs with Mo. Maybe things... Oh, wait, no, that was Nazer that spoke that. And then here I am trying to sound like Mo. Maybe things won't be so bad after all. Hoping for, but not expecting, a scene where a long-necked dino like Liz is swimming in the lake with her head way up in the water and a Loch Ness joke. If you're going to crash, crash with style. Remember, when he caught those kids doing carfoot by the boat launch, he was all professional cop on them and threatened to book them. I can't help but smile. Listening to them reminisce helps me relax as I steer the boat towards the buoys like Mr. Aaron wanted. Holy fuck, that Anon body type. Somebody say carf? We all laugh as Reed hops down from somewhere on the roof. He has his rod in one hand and the strange bit mixture in the other. Bait mixture, sorry. Do a flip. Come to think of it, what's in that stuff anyways? Hey Reed, have you ever been fishing before? Nope, I borrowed this rod from a collection of my grandpa's old junk. Works pretty well though. So what's in the bait then? Carf? I kind of figured it had to be. Until I saw the weird look Reed was giving me. He shakes his head. No, dude. Like worms and chum and shit. Alright, drink time. Oof. Eventually, I'm able to expertly steer the boat into the area Mr. Aaron wanted. I check back and he gives me the thumbs up. The lines he set out allows them to trail behind as the boat moves. The boat sways gently in the calm waters, all of us taking a moment to relax as our cast lines sit behind us. Mr. Aaron is handing out drinks he had brought along, beers for himself and Mo, and cold sodas for us underage folk. I down mine quickly and Nazer hands me another. So, Anon, do humans still use spears and stuff to fish? Seems like they'd come in handy in shallow waters. Nazer and his unintended racisms. You know, because you can stand and throw it when the fish get close. He coughs to clear the awkward silence. I swear he does this on purpose. Maybe he's actually curious, or after Jesus knows I'm just as bad. I'll throw him a bone to clear the air. Left it at home. Spearfishing is a lot easier said than done. But we usually just use fishing rods like everyone else. That makes sense, yeah? What about... Snap. Moe's line snaps taut behind him, causing him to jump and stumble back a bit. Hey, looks like I got hooked something big. We all huddle close as Moe snatches his rod up and yanks it back. Oh boy, this punk's a fighter! The line cuts through the water, back and forth, splashing as it stirs up even more ripples. Moe holds his pole close to his chest. It seems to be the only way he can actually hold it. Spear fishing is cool. Net. Mr. Aaron still holds his lifeless fishing rod. Before I can ask what he means, Nazer scrambles below deck, coming back up with a large fishing net he must have grabbed from one of the closets. I like how it seems that humans are treated like African... Patricia's an American black. Yeah, it seems like it. Come on, ain't got all day. Coming! Careful, bro, watch the tail! I think I can see it! There's a sound like a cracking whip, and before any of us have time to react, Moe falls backwards onto the rest of us. Ah, damn it all, the line snapped on me. I heads it! Wish I could respond, but my lungs were crushed beneath the weight of the massive T-Rex on top of me. I see. Light. Thankfully, Mr. Irwin pulls Moe off of me as I managed to suck sweet oxygen back into my lungs. That was him. You could tell by the way it fought. You think so, Rip? I know so. The what? I'm gonna turn this down a bit. El Gigante? Did I just have a stroke? Or was that mariachi trumpet? A monster of a catch, if he can ever be caught. Mr. Earn squints, scanning the local horizon. Pale and white, like the gossamer rays of the moonlight. Some say it was a salmon that swam upstream from Mexico. Got caught up and tangled in a castaway block of... contraband. Sun Spanish, yes. Contraband. Legends say he swallowed it all without flinching. Rosa in the back. Rosa stored away. She's a refugee. Reed helps me up and joins me as we listen to Mr. Aaron spin his fishtail. So, you guys... think that's the thing we had on the line? Moe nods as he hovers over the tackle box and fastens on a new hook to his line. Feels like we're in an episode of Johnny Test with the whip. All the whip sounds, yeah. Like, I think they really overdone it with that. Oh, it's getting a little dark in my room. I'm gonna turn on some lights real quick. That way I'm not, like, dozing off. The bright lights will keep me awake. Hey, y'all. Hey, Mr. Laughable. The best ending is Rosa catching it with her bare hands out of nowhere. I could see that happening. The way it moves. He has a pattern. I can't tell you how many times I've seen it. Well, let's catch this beast then, Brolios. Tomorrow. The sun's just about to set. Full day of fishing has me famished. Rain on, take us to shore. Piloting the boat has been easy so far. This should be a cruise. I feel like I'm in the 1800s with all this whipping. Oh no. Oh, what a joke. I take my time as I spin the wheel and ease the throttle. I hope Mr. Aaron is looking. The boat crawls through the water as the sky darkens. For the first time since I got to the lake, I feel at peace. When a problem comes along, you must whip it. Just whip it. The tranquil waters, the cool breeze, and the insects chirping. I feel... comfortable. Comfortable. I could talk! My god. Until that presence returns. Yes, back at Volcano High, Rosa suddenly looks up at the sound of distant... the distant mariachi. I am summoned. Miguel, we are harvesting the cotton with this one. My God. Chad is wild. You need help docking the boat, Anon? Shit. Do I? Do it yourself, Percy. Oh boy. Another save. Whew. I have zero idea what I'm doing. Let's play it safe. Cause I never docked the boat when I was piloting. Yeah, if you don't mind. Porku really likes visual novels until he gets to narrate them. Yeah, no one likes my narration, I'm pretty sure. They're just here. They're here for the snoot, and I'm here for the snoot too. Mr. Aaron is laughing? It's gruff and short, but I'm pretty sure that was a laugh. I'm sure you'll be fine. What? Why did he ask then? And with that, he left me to do my duty. This has to be similar to parallel parking, right? All I have to do is spin the wheel and... I never parallel parked. Oh boy. Live for the snoot. We all do. We dock the boat in short order and move to dinner prep. The grill sizzles with a variety of tantalizing meats. Oh, is that supposed to... Look at it! Oh, wait, no, that's the table. I was going to say that was a really pathetic-looking grill. Is the table going to speak to us next? The only veggies visible are on the chicken kebabs that Breed had brought. I'm the closest thing here to a herbivore, but I'll be damned if I'm not crying vegan. I can eat meat with the best carnivores. Burger or hot dog? Why not both? As I grab my meat from off the grill, I notice Reed is heading back to his van with his share of kebabs and dogs. Figure now is good time as ever to thank him for helping me today. Bwomp sound effect. I don't know what I'm doing. Me either. I jog to catch up to him, careful not to topple my plate of delicacies. Hey Reed, wait up! Hey, Anon, enjoying the kebabs? They're great, but I actually wanted to talk to you about earlier today. Agreeing to help, I mean. Reed puts a hand to stop me. Don't sweat it, Rotato Chip. I'm always glad to spend some quality time with my homies. Interacting with Reed is always a mixed bag. You never know what you're gonna get when you talk to him. No matter his level of engagement, though, he's been the most trustworthy friend I've had since I started at Volcano High. Need more snoot boop. Yeah, where's Fang? We haven't seen Fang yet. I want my money back! I know that this song was in Snoot Game, but it sounds like a knockoff of that song, The Family Guy episode about Peter meeting death. I wouldn't know. I don't really watch Family Guy. The most Family Guy I've been watching lately is the Peter AI shit that's on YouTube. That shit's got some wild stuff going through it. In fact, he was the first friend I made in a long time. We even have stuff in common. And as comfortable as I was ending the conversation there, something kept me around. I think I mustered up the right thing to say to Reed. I owe it at least partially for him for how far I've come. It's not just that. I want to thank you for everything you've done for me. You invited me to hang out with your friend group when I had no friends. Even when I pushed you away and resisted, you stuck to your guns and pulled me along. Crazy shit and all. And if it wasn't for you, chances are I'd still be a loner looking to just piss the school year away. I owe you big time, Reed. I just want you to know that I'm really glad you're my friend. A genuine smile spreads across Reed's snout as he nods along with what I have to say. Bro, that's some deep stuff. He hesitantly pats my shoulder as he absorbs my words. Fang is doing her own stuff. Remember the start? Yeah, I know, but still, I was promised Fang at the start. Someone said Fang appears at, like, the start and end, so someone lied to me. Whoever drew this read sprite doesn't know that they have unleashed for the fan artists. When he speaks again, his voice is quieter, more genuine, with no slurred words. That really means a lot to me, man. I'm glad I could ride along with you through senior year. And for all the crazy problems we had to deal with so far, I like really think the whole band is better off with you by our side. He gives me a single finger gun as he flops backward onto his hammock with his plate of food. When does this take place? Sometime during the school year, probably wasn't it like May? The end of May? So it's close to summer. Come on, take a load off so we can chow down. We can discuss poor life choices and laugh at our mistakes. That sounds pretty great to me. I'm starving. And we're already an hour in, guys. So according to, I forget, was it Zen who said that? Or was it Lemon that said it was like 2 hours? The rest of the evening was spent laughing with Reed and retelling our high school experiences before I transferred. Reed tells me about how he originally met Trish and Fang, and I tell him about the time I scammed some kids out of $50 for a broken laptop I found. Eventually, Mr. Aaron declares that he's calling lights out and herds us all to the cabin. The cabin is cozy, and I swap my trunks and tank top for a pair of pajama pants and a t-shirt when I have the chance. Laser does the same, switching from the fugly Hawaiian t-shirt he brought to a pair of gym shorts and a tank top that gives his wings more space. We need a mod with a crossover with Fang and Olivia talking about his humans. Yeah, we need the Snoot Wani crossover mod. I don't know if they're going to make it for, like, Snoot game or if they're going to make it for Wani Gator. Reed bids us a good night and retires to his van. Mr. Aaron leaves for his room, and Mo takes the spare. Nazer and I encounter a problem, however, one we had to discuss earlier. And I was spoiled to this, because I was browsing Twitter, and I happened upon it. But if you know, you know. Now let me grab a drink. So, how are we doing this? Am I the big spoon? You can take the right side. I've got the left. Not exactly the 5 feet separation we need, but we have little choice. I guess it's better than nothing. In on an Inko revealing they are, in fact, cousins. Well, someone's gonna, if it's a mod, someone's gonna do that for sure. All right. Just don't think too hard about it. I know I'm not. We both slide into the bed on our agreed upon sides, leaving a solid 2 feet between us. I wonder which of us is hanging further off of their side of the bed. Laser turns the lamp off that was on his side, washing the room in darkness. I hear him turn his back to me. I try sleeping at first, but I find it kind of difficult. While the mattress is comfier than what I'm used to, I can't seem to get into a good position. Resigning myself to a sleeplessness, I grab my phone from the floor next to me and punch in my passcode. There's no internet here! And surprisingly, I have no reception, but at some point I must have pinged a tower just long enough to get for a text message to slip through to me. Better be Fang. I feel like Inko wouldn't get along with Anon so well. It was from Fang. Good night, dweeb. Hope you're not dead. A smile spreads across my face. From behind me, I hear Nazer shift again. Anon is too based for Inko. Do you have to have that on? Sorry, got a text from Fang. At least dim your phone screen. I can see it from over my shoulder. I elect to shut my phone off instead. It's time for some precious edge-of-the-bud sleep. A precarious edge of the bed sleep. If I could read. At some point in the night, I wake up to the weight of the bed shifting. I can feel the mattress spring up slightly and the covers jostle. I hear Nazar sigh as he walks from the room. I stay quiet for the time being, expecting to hear the bathroom door down the hall shut. But it doesn't. Instead, I hear the sliding glass door open up. What is Nazar up to? If a Nazar shits in the woods and nobody's around to hear it, do I go check? Whatever it is doesn't concern me, probably. But part of me is still curious to see where he's gone off to at this time of the night. Or what ending does this go from? Probably 3 or 4, as everyone's guessing. Anon would hate the fact that Inko has MCU posters and watches shitty You Snoot reviewers, yeah. Inko's a fucking normie. I give it another minute or two just to be safe before I slip myself out from under the covers. I quietly tiptoe down the hall and back to the living room. I'm not trying to feel the wrath of Ripper or Mr. Aaron if he wakes up. It's dim, the room illuminated from the full moon through the window. Ahead of me, I can see the door to Ripley's bar was left ajar. Light pours out from the other side. I wonder who's there. I slowly slink over to the door and peer through the crack. A set of stairs leads down to what I presume is the basement. I can hear Moe's unmistakable humming from below. I need to read. Pretty sure ending 4 is the only canon ending. I mean, it's not like it can be ending 1. Yeah, Fang died and we're doing this. As my eyes drift, I can see the sliding glass door across the room is in fact open, letting all of the mosquitoes in. Wherever Nazar went, he's outside somewhere. Maybe I should talk to Mo. I'm kind of curious as to what Mr. Aaron's man cave looks like, too. I'm still curious about Nazar. That sigh sounded like something was on his mind. You know what we gotta do. We gotta save. And we gotta talk to Nazar. I could chat with Mo later. I quietly slip out through the sliding glass door, heading after Nazar. Anon wants to be an audio engineer. An audio engineer, and then Inko's like a filmographer or whatever. And Fang doing good. Talk with the Nazar. God damn it, Zen. Where did he get to? He's not around to the side of the house. That's why I remember the ladder to the roof. I'm willing to bet he's up there, too, just like Fang on the school's rooftop. I slowly ascend the ladder, the cold metal sending goosebumps up from where my bare feet make contact. Sure enough, we got some art here. Perfect time to get a drink. Nazar is lying down on the slanted roof, hands behind his head and staring up at the full moon and stars. I figured you'd follow me up here. I figured you might want some company. I heave myself over to the side and walk over to where he is. I take an awkward moment to brush aside the dead pine needles and lie down. Anon is a woman. Oh god, now you made me, you pointed it out and it's like, oh, now I can't unsee it. Thanks a lot. Just some bros on the roof. Art not looking too fine. Well, they worked on a $0 budget, so. The shingles dig in a bit, but at least I won't fall off and slam into the ground below. Bros, close your eyes. What do you see? Nothing, bro. That's my life without you, bro. You come to play therapist again? I don't mind helping a friend out. I can see a small smile flash across his beak for a second before it disappears again. I guess. I'm just worried for the future. We're almost out of high school, and I'm still conflicted on what I want to do. I know it's going to be hard, but with what you've done for Fang and for me, I think I can rest a little easier knowing those things, you know? Thanks to you, Fang and I are talking again, like we used to. My relationship with her was crap ever since I got hurt, and then you came in and And in a few months, you managed to patch in the holes. Enon Tedos. He turns to me with a smile. I don't know how you pulled it off, but I'm thankful, Enon. I go to speak, but I could see his smile falter as he looks back up to the stars. I'm still unsure about medical school, though, or other personal things. He sighs as he lowers, as his gaze lowers to the lake. I still want to be a doctor. I want to help people. I know I've screwed that up before, though. Thoughts of Fang and the way he's tried to help her flash through my mind. In a weird way, it's kind of nice. I'm finally figuring myself out instead of worrying over others. My future is in my hands. I don't have to worry about keeping Dad happy anymore. Nazer shrugs and glances at me again. I'll find a way to make it work, though. Thanks for listening to me again. I feel a hell of a lot better getting that off my chest. It's the least I can do. You've done plenty for me. I hear Nazer scoff at that. The only thing I did was push you into a locker when I lost my temper. Nazer. I sit up and speak in a more serious tone. It prompts him to mirror me and sit up as well. He cocks an eyebrow. Nazer, you were the first person to be genuinely nice to me. You gave up half your sandwich to a total stranger just so I'd have something to eat. The bigger half, too. You helped coax me out of my shell when I tried to hide from the world. I rest a reassuring hand on his shoulder. He tenses, but only for a moment. Without your help, I never would have been able to date Fang right. I was in way over my head. I had no idea where to begin. I should be the one thanking you for everything you've done for me. You've been a real bro from the start. You're one of the few people out there I know I can count on. It means a lot to me. I pat his shoulders and he lays back on the roof. I turn my head to the stars as well so he doesn't see the emotion on my face. I never had a best friend before. But I like to think to myself that Nazer fits that role. I know we haven't known each other for even half a year, but you're my best friend, Nazer. I don't know a single person willing to do what you have and not expect anything in return. Out of the corner of my eye, I notice he's looking at me. He's beaming. A wide smile overtakes his face. I hope. I swallow a growing lump in my throat. I hope I can keep doing you proud by being the best boyfriend I can be for Fang. Silence. He doesn't speak at first. Emotions feel strange. Maybe I said too much? I can see him shake his head. It's nothing, Anon, really. I'd do anything for Fang. Or anybody she cares about. She's family. Just like you. That stung my heart. I can feel the lump grow back. It hurts, but in a good way. My own family never cared about me. I was always treated as a liability. A roommate more than a son. True friendship unlock. But with this group of misfits and screw-ups, I have something I've never had before. Even if we aren't blood related. A real family. One that actually wants me around. Just like Inko and the Pains. That means a lot, Nazer. Thank you. Don't worry about it, man. Silence envelops us as I lay back down. A quick glance to Nazer, and it looks like if a huge weight has been lifted off his shoulders. We gaze at the stars. Maybe I'm good for something after all. Shame I'll never see any money for this therapy stuff. Drink time. And I'm becoming the second son to the Aaron family. Oof. I can hear the sliding glass doors open wider than what we had had it cracked to. Oh God, what if it's Mr. Aaron? Hey, who's up on the roof? Whew, only Mo. Nazer sits up and looks over the edge of the roof. It's just Anon and I. Well, come on down. I'll make us a fire and we can all chit-chat. We make our way down the ladder as Mo lights up a fire in the pit. All the Pains had The pains before they found out Inko uses charcoal instead of propane. This is my sleeping apron. Hold on, let me... There we go. Wait, is what is that? Jurassic Puff? Jurassic Puff? My god. He even had a stuff for the s'mores he must have grabbed from somewhere in the cabin. So, what were you two talking about up on that roof, huh? Lady troubles? I guess. Still worried about Dad? Yeah, why wouldn't I be? Now we talking. You ain't got nothing to fear, kid. Now, believe it or not, you and him have a lot in common. I could hear Mo laugh. Ain't that the truth? That's what I've been saying. They're both awkward and nervous, just in their own ways. Nice, it almost looks official. It does almost look official. This is where the budget went to, guys. This piece alone. And that's supposed to make me feel better? It's true, you're the first guy Fang has brought home. Well, the first guy she's interested in. I overheard Dad talking to Mom about it. He was legitimately worried he might have been too hard on you. He said the same thing to me. I was taken aback, feeling the emotional whiplash. Maybe Mo wasn't bullshitting this time. S'mores came true after all. What budget? He was? Was he ever? He came to me for advice. He hasn't done that in 10 years. It's kind of weird, but I think he actually didn't know what to do. He usually has all the answers. What am I supposed to do then? It seems like everything I do only gets him more pissed off at me. I could see Mo wave one of his tiny hands dismissively. Nah, he's just frustrated. He don't know what to make of ya, is all. Can't get a read on ya. Just give him a chance, listen to his stories, and pay attention when he wants you to teach you something. He's sharing one of his favorite pastimes with you. Least he could do is take it seriously. Mo opens a big bag of marshmallows and starts to pass out ingredients for s'mores. You're a good kid, Anon. I have a good feeling you can figure this out. I feel a hand rest on my shoulder. I turn to see Nazer giving me a reassuring grin. Yeah, don't worry, man. Mo and I have your back. I couldn't help but smile. Maybe I was in good hands. Well, I suppose this is an all-star team. I don't have too much to worry about. Three of us laugh as we enjoy our late-night treats around the bonfire. Maybe, just maybe, I can find a decent way to bond with Mr. Aaron. That certainly helps that I have everyone else in my corner. Drink time. I still have yet to try. You still have yet to try s'mores. Can't have shit in Argentina. One day. The rest of the night went by quickly. Fatigue set in after we all had our fair share, and then some, of s'mores. Name brand carbs and sugars always taste better than store brand. Oh god, this is the part I got spoiled to, guys. You know what's coming. I stir in the comfy bed I find myself in now, still fading in and out of consciousness. Snuggled up next to me is a familiar warm presence. I gently massage the smooth scales under my hand as I kiss Fang's neck. I don't remember her staying the night. Oh god. You're so warm, Fang. This bed feels a lot bigger than I remember. Naomi, stop it. Wait. Oh no. We seem to realize and then wake up at the same time. It was Nazer. I just kissed. Oh god, oh fuck. Now they are true brothers. Ah! We both scramble from the bed in a spastic flurry of arms and legs. Mazer is quick to his feet while I fall face first and taste oak that made up the floor. Oh. I quickly stumble to my feet as we point accusatory fingers at each other. You kissed my neck! I didn't know it was you! Besides, you were cuddling me! No, no, no! You were spooning me! How the fuck did you manage to, with that with my wings? I refuse to believe this was my doing. Well, it wasn't me who initiated it. Let's never speak of this again. From this moment forward, we act as if that never happened. Agreed. If anybody asks about the scream, it was a big-ass frog. Yeah, sure, that works. Big-ass frog. Poor Jerry getting blamed for everything. Grab another drink. Bro sleep head to toe. The Spider-Man meme. And with that, we go about our day. We do our best to scrub the last 10 minutes from our brains. We take our sweet time getting ready. We were up early, so it allows us to get a bit of relaxation in a day or two before day two of fishing starts. Talk about a big-ass frog. I have a pet frog. Frogs are cool. Mr. Aaron walks into the room at exactly 7. Huh. Looks like he went for a jog. Breakfast is eggs and bacon. Despite me offering to help, Mo is firm in taking care of the cooking. Snitches go swimming. Sorry, Anon. Cooking is my gig. Don't go stepping on my toes. After breakfast, we quickly pack up the boat and head out back out in the open water. Bee moment. How did Anon be the big spoon with Nazer's wings? Or with Fang, for that matter? I don't know. It's another sunny day, and I can feel the heat already threatening to peel the skin off my head. I make sure to paint it white with sunscreen before we go out. Reed spots me and smirks. You really burn that bad, man? You're darn snooting. We need to borrow some sunscreen? Reed snickers as if I told a joke. I'm good, bro. Us dinos don't burn like humans. We love the heat. I'll be fine. Are dinos immune to sunburns? Yeah, you can tell this was made after Wani. This was totally made after Wani. Especially the demo. What do you get when you mix a helicopter, an elephant, and a rhino? Helifino? Hell if I know. Okay. You take your bad jokes elsewhere. Why are Anon and Inko both bald? It's because it's the... What do you call it? The anonymous template of bald man. Usually green, but today we're white. We love the heat. Motherfuckers screaming when they see a meteor. We don't talk about Volcano High. He will regret that. Mo's last apron reminds him of many business associates he's lost over the years. Muppets reference. In the Snoot world, there is probably something like a... I'm not reading that. Oh god, I swallowed wrong. I'm gonna mute real quick. I hate when I swallow wrong. We board the boat, and Mr. Aaron has me at the helm again. He requests me to take us close to the shallows. After the heart-to-heart last night, I'm feeling much more confident. I take the boat to where Mr. Aaron wants and sets the anchor. Right here's good, Anon. Alright, boys, let's set up. The five of us grab up our rods and cast out. I'm able to do most of the setup myself, using what was taught yesterday. We don't talk about Volcano. No. I think dino skin is resistant to sunburns, probably. Don't quote me. I even managed to tie a decent knot under the hook. I think the support I received is working. Mr. Earn hasn't looked at me funny once since we started fishing. We even managed to catch another 2 fish today. So what do you think, Anon? About what? Fishing, you punk. You having fun? I guess that one time I got a nibble was pretty cool. I was a plastic bag, bro. A guy can dream, can't he? I hate it when I swallow wrong. Hey, don't take that out of context. I have issues. I have digesting issues, if you know what I mean. I choke on my own spit sometimes, and that just, it ruins, like, these moments. One day, I'm gonna, like, just choke on my spit wrong while I'm reading something super emotional, and it's gonna kill the moment. Mark my words. Nazer laughs. Don't worry, Anon. Maybe one day you'll... He's cut off by the sound of his reel spinning in his hands. Everybody turns to him as he wrestles the handle back with wide eyes. It's him! El Gigante. No, like this. Gigante. I'm sorry, was that a whip crack? Am I high? I've been microdosing this entire time, bro. Can you fuckers help me? Reed and I stumbled towards Nazer to offer assistance, only to have him fall back on us after a loud snap on his line. Bro, I choke on my spit sometimes too, it sucks. Yeah, it's definitely a life skill issue. Damn it, just like yesterday. Rip, where are you keeping the heavier stuff? I suppose we don't have much of a choice now. I remove myself from the entanglement with Reed and Nazer. What do you mean? Thicker line, son. We're going to catch that son of a bitch. God, I hope so. Nazer and I help Reed to his feet again, but his stare seems to be glued to something out across the water. His eyes are small like almond slices, and his mouth is curved down in worry. Reed, you okay, buddy? Yeah, I just gotta take care of something real quick. Before anyone else can speak, he disappears below deck with his tail between his legs. Mr. Aaron steps up and raises a hand to block the glare of sun from his eyes. Is that Principal Spears? Oh, no. Is that Principal Spears? Who's that? Principal Spears? Oh my god. Oh, that's great. Got another high quality piece here. That's cool. The 1800s sound moment. Good thing Trish isn't here. Oh boy. I turn and spot the caveman in question. Sure as shit, he's in a small speedboat about 2 times smaller than he is and speeding towards us. He looks almost cartoonish speeding along in such a small vessel. It isn't long before he reaches us. He boards the ship. Oh boy. Salutations, Mr. Aaron. He nods to Nazer and I. Here comes the best character. Nazer, Anon, good morning. Mr. Earn folds his arms. Is there something we can help you with, Principal Spears? He pushes his glasses into place as he clears his throat. I certainly hope so. Apologies for interrupting you all for so far from school grounds, but I have reasons to believe that there might be some missing school property out here on this lake or close by. He turns to Nazer and I. I have good reason to believe that your friend Reed may have brought back the Volcano High mascot costume up to this lake at some point in the last week. I can harbor a guess as to what would spur him to do such a thing as well. Reed needs to hide. Tell me, boys, do you know anything about this? My eyes flick to Mr. Aaron, and I can tell he wants to say something. He catches my gaze and raises an eyebrow. Before I can think of what to say, I'm already responding. We got the illusion of choice here again. Hold that thought. I gotta hit the head. I quickly remove myself from the situation, nodding to Nazer as I scurry below the deck. Thankfully, it seems as if Nazer understands where I'm going and that... with that, and nods back. No one can say Spears ain't a competent school principal. He just knows. Wow, man's dedicated to his job. Only someone that badass can make such a ridiculous arrival genuinely somewhat alarming. That dude's on something. Oh boy, we got the cabin. Nice and cozy. Probably looks bigger than it actually is. I find myself below deck. I know I saw Reed sneak down here. Where'd he go? Anon, that you, bro? Reed, what are you doing in that closet? I can see him peek his muzzle out through the door. His spear's gone, bro. Not yet. He's looking for you. Oh, no. Reed, you gotta come clean, dude. What did you do with King Rex? Reed steps out from his hiding spot and rubs his arm. There's guilt and desperation written on his face. Well, you remember earlier at school when I said I had a bad trip. I swear to God, it was aliens, man. Little dudes guided me out here and told me to take the costume out of my van and throw it out in the middle of the lake. What? What in the artificial fuck? Spears in his tiny boat with a hula something of his life. I can't. It's because of that stupid heart react. I'm just gonna click it. Fuck this. Oh, I can't. Oh no. Well, looks like I'm pulling out chat from YouTube. You know, I'm gonna click it here. Click it. Yeah, cool. So cool. I love this feature. All right, pop out chat because I just killed it on OBS. Thank you, OBS. It's read over. It's read off. It's Jover. All right. Why? They needed it as a sacrifice for the higher beings, man. I don't know. That shit I took was crazy. The pink raptor grabs my shoulders tight and stares me dead in the eyes. Please, dude, you gotta cover for me. I can't have Spears on my ass again, dude. Be a bro, please. Lie to the caveman? Can he smell that kind of stuff? Reed, if Spears finds out we went in on this together, we'll both end up folded into pretzels. He won't, bro, I promise. Looks like I had to make a split-second decision on this. Let me go talk to him. Oh boy. I shake my head as I make my way to topside. Reed's quiet begging fading behind me. Spears sees me and nods. Anon, I hope everything is okay. My eyes dart around the group. Mr. Aaron and Nazer are focused on me. Mo seems to have preoccupied himself with trying to attach some cold pizza as bait for his hook. It's all ogre. Mover. I love fishing but hate the taste of fish. I don't know, I like fish. Yeah, everything's fine. I think I know what happened to the mascot costume, though. Alright, oh boy, I want to admit the truth because just lying in front of Ripley and the principal is not going to be good. You can't lie in front of them. I have to admit the truth. Tell the truth. Yeah, that's what I was thinking. Or telling the truth. Honesty is the best policy. I'm pretty sure the costume is here. Reed told me there was some stuff that happened and the costume ended up in the lake. I can feel all eyes on me. I can only assume what Nazer and Mr. Aaron are thinking right now. That's all I really know. He said it was an accident and he's really sorry. My reassurance goes unnoticed by Principal Spears as he scratches his chin. My assumptions to Reed's involvement were correct. I had little doubt. His mishandling of the costume is something that he will definitely need to be spoken to about, especially in a situation as this. I'm growing tired of his antics with that costume. Now that I have confirmation, however, hopefully I'll be able to find it. I certainly hope no damage has befallen it, for Wreath's sake. I can see Spears offer me a smile and a nod. I appreciate your honesty, Anon, especially when it comes to Reed. He is certainly misguided, but he is a bright young raptor. Hopefully some corrective action will help him mature. His shoulder sags as he sighs. One can hope. It sounds like Reed ain't gonna be punished too bad. I nod as he starts up the small engine on his boat and speeds off. I let out a breath I didn't know I was holding in and looked to Nazer and Mr. Aaron. Nazer's eyes were on the floor as he was shaking his head. Mr. Aaron had a complex look on his face. I couldn't tell which emotion he was trying to convey. Thankfully, Mo is there to break the tension. Hey, you punks, how about we get back to fishing? Yo, guys. Is Spears gone? Yeah. Reed peeks his head out from below deck. The stoner cautiously slinks above deck with his head on a constant swivel. We're climbing back to where he was to continue his sunbathing. Care to explain to me what that was about? Don't know. Principal Spears wanted to know about the costume, so I told him what I knew. Uh-huh. That didn't sound so genuine. What was he thinking about, I wonder? I guess we did something wrong. We were supposed to lie, guys. Lying is good to impress the dad we're trying to fucking get in good graces with for our girlfriend's sake. Reed's gonna be hit by a meteor. Lie to Spears and you are dead. We move back to fishing for a time. Nothing much is caught except for the two fish from before Principal Spears stopped by. It was as if the fish were avoiding us. Are steering clear of El Gigante. Honesty, best policy. That's what I'm thinking. But you never know with Snoot Game. Or Wani. Damn, 2 hours and not even a nibble. It's better to lie. Well, I'll lie to you then. I'll keep that in mind and I'll lie to you. Every time. It'll happen. Gotta get used to it. It gives us time to all get to know each other the better, bros. Like, did you dudes know I have a third nut? I have a third nut! Everybody's heads turned so fast I could hear a collective pop of our necks. In both games, being honest is good. What the fuck, Reed? I mean, not with me, but I have it. I can hear Mr. Aaron clear his throat. So what would you all think the biggest animal you could fight and kill barehanded is? I'm almost disappointed that the subject was changed. I want to be friends with my father-in-law. I was morbidly curious about Reed's apparent childhood in Chernobyl. I suppose if I was given some prep time, I could probably take down a coyote or a rattlesnake. Or maybe even a small bobcat. Mr. Aaron smiles and nods his head. Let me guess, a rhino. He's gonna take on a rhino. Very respectable, son. Oh, I remember when I went boar hunting once. Guns jammed as I was taking my shot. Beast Mo killing boars out here? Holy crap. I'd wrestle the son of a bitch to the ground and kill him the old-fashioned way. So I can factually say a boar. Damn. What about you, Rip? I guessed it. I fucking guessed it, guys. Someone fucking give me an award. I guessed it. He said a rhino. I fucking got it right. Dude, I can gauge this guy, man. I almost choke on the bullshit. You've all seen my trophy rack back home. Probably could take a coyote, too. His eyes narrow on me. I wasn't lying when I said I never used a gun. No way. No way in hell. I mean, sure, Mr. Earn was built like a brick shithouse, but a rhino is all muscle. But I would struggle with a kangaroo. Maybe he gave it a heart attack with his terrifying stare. A rhino. What about you, Anon? What about me? What's the biggest animal you could kill, huh? Let me guess, it's giving me a choice. Sparrow, squirrel, rat. Oh my god. How pathetic. Well, a squirrel is definitely more dangerous than a rat. If you piss it off. I don't know, sparrow? Oh, this has got to be like a fake choice here. Rat. Do we go with rat just because rats are cool? I mean, rats are cool. We're gonna take on guts. Capybara. I mean, capybaras can wild out, you know. If the males aren't neutered, they do get territorial. Rat. Everyone goes quiet before bursting out laughing. Ouch, my ego. That's it? Oh, kid, that's pathetic. Yeah, ha ha ha. I bet if I put my mind to it, I could take something bigger. Grizzly bear, Anon. Yes, and because guts. The group scoffs at my attempt to cover my ass. Was there really any choice? It was rigged from the start. Eventually, their laughter dies down and we get back to fishing. Oh, dang. Another good art piece. Anon can take on Fang in honor of guts. Perfect time to get a drink. I need to go get more water, so I'm going to mute real quick. I had to restock the water in the fridge so I get cold water. I could take on a human. With that comment, his dad put you in the trophy room. Boys, what about a bear? And Anon does look good. More like the bottom of the lake. I don't know, the only thing I could choke is Fang. Damn it, Zen! Go fucking... Get a drink, you're thirsty. Lands right on El Gigante. Gigante. Alright, let's get a drink real quick. Alright. I hear a splash from somewhere close to the bow of the boat, and see Nazer resurface. Come on in, bros, the water's fine. The heat was getting uncomfortable. You three go on ahead. Mo and I are gonna grab a beer. Man, this mod is so chill. It is! Him and Mo reel in the rest of the lines and head to the fridge while Reed and I jump into the lake shallows. Woo! Yeah! The water is nice. I can't even remember the last time I went swimming. The water isn't too deep, and it's just cool enough to soothe my head. At some point, Nazer reveals he brought a disposable camera and suggests we take some pictures while we're on the lake. Well, that's Inko's job. It's hard for a camera to capture my good side when I don't really have one. Maybe if we ever catch this El Gigante, I'll consider my picture getting taken. Or getting my picture taken. Wait, why'd you remove your message? I just saw the message retracted. I could see, you could remove your message, but it'll always be immortalized in the on-screen chat. Just letting you guys know that if you ever retract your messages, they're going to be immortalized on the stream. Meteor ending where the meteor just goes to swim, not kill when. I could see Reed float by, using his tail to propel him lazily through the water. So, Anon, I gotta know. Yeah? I know I shouldn't pry, but what have you and Fang been up to? You know, since the, He doesn't finish his sentence, but we all know where he's going with it. I brush it off and shrug. Nothing, really. We've just been getting to know each other better. Right. Oh no, he popped in on the side. What are you doing there, Ripley? I can see both Nazer and his father's head pop up during the conversation. I gotta reword that before I become sashimi. I mean in the sense of personality. For example, she likes it when I cook for us. Nazer seems to understand and nods. I see where you're coming from. When Naomi sneezes, she sounds like a kitten. My girl's always talking about geology. She loves the shit, I swear. Wait, Reed's dating someone? Who's Reed dating? Anon been taking on Fang. Honestly, I like Inko more than Anon. Well, that's respectable, I guess. Super Mallow just subscribed. Thanks for the sub. But my girl's always who's Reed's dating? Who is he dating? And we just don't know about that shit. I'm genuinely lost. Wait, Reed, you have a girlfriend? More like a friends with benefits thing. Her name's Ambrosia. Uh-oh. Friends with benefits. I could have probably guessed her name if you gave me enough time. Who knows geology in the games? No one. Reed is dating the weed. So what other things has Fang opened up to you about, Anon? Well, I know if you boop or snoot and crest at the same time, she takes a screenshot. I couldn't help but chuckle at my stupid joke. Nazer smirks and cocks an eyebrow. Is that right? I'm pretty sure he was catching on now, or at least entertaining my stupid humor. I guess. I never knew Fang was ambidextrous with most instruments she played. Ah, she was always worried she would lose a hand or something somehow, so she learned how to play with both. That seems a bit paranoid, yeah. So I suppose Fang's gotten you into instruments then. I mean, she's trying to teach me guitar. I guess I've learned a little. So what is it you do when you're not with my daughter, then? The Tarot Patriarch's injection almost made me jump from the water. I can hear sirens blare in my head. There they are. I think Reed was planning to date Trish. I don't see that happening. Lots of guitar lessons, that's all I swear. I cannot let him find out what kind of neat-like shenanigans I get up to. Oh, you know, nothing to write home about. I'm just a typical guy. TV, homework, bed. I finish off with a less than genuine laugh. He doesn't buy it for a second. I'm pretty sure I heard Lucy mention something about anime. What is that? No. Fuck no. Not now. Not ever. Deflect. Hey, Nazer! Huh? Your dad brings up a good question. What do you usually do in your free time besides sports and school stuff? I was always curious about that. I see him more of dating Rose. I don't see that. I can feel a glare shot from me from Mr. Aaron's direction, but I do my best to ignore it and focus on Nazer. Well, for starters, I like to work on my car. The NASCAR. The scratches don't buff themselves, you know. That's an understatement. Well, I'm not doing that. I got a little side gig of buying and selling Kanyes. It was pricey to get into, but the scratch I get now is usually enough for the next new pair. Then all I have to do is wait a couple of months for them to become an exclusive or a collector's item and then sell them for double what I bought them for. Neptunia jump scare. It's a decent way to pass the time, and it gets me some cash. Kanyes? What is up with Nazer's sprite? Did Nazer ever look like this? He's got like a jawbone going. Nazer, did you have a stroke, Nazer? Well, you having a stroke there? Designer shoes. Shoes, you say? Funny you mention that. Whenever I'm away from the oven, I relax with some cobbling. Bo makes shoes? What kind of shoes do you make? Now, Mr. Krabs, well, as I code him as Mr. Krabs, is a person I know. Yeah, Mr. Krabs was a shoemaker. Well, not a shoemaker, but a shoe repairsman. So, this kind of hits home a little bit. Nazer buying NFTs to sell. Bang's dad is so badass. Scary. Most of them are my own design, seeing as I got massive stompers. Mo lifts a foot to show off his Doc shoes. See these here? Made them myself from designs I saw in a catalog. To my surprise, Mo's shoes are surprisingly well put together. Few if no flaws are detailed stitch work. The leather is a nice tan color too. Mo makes excellent concrete slippers. Oh no. They was asking $100 for them, so I made them for less than half. As he laughs, I can see Reed float by again. His pink scales have a darker hue to them than they did earlier. You dudes want to know my special hobbies are? Outside of percussion instruments? Drugs? Skooma? Spacing out? Oh, herbalism? I make sure to use air quotes, but I think everyone knew where I was going with it. Reed rolls his eyes. No, dudes. I volunteered down at the Volcadera Animal Shelter. I love animals, man. It's sweet to learn about that kind of stuff. Reed is high as fuck. And when I'm not doing that, I like to write romance fanfics for my favorite visual novel video game. What the fuck? Oh, gotta get some meta humor in there. Moe's is a Morrowind nerd. I don't know. I suffer whiplash. Oof. Romance? Visual novel? What happened to games like Peachy Man or Racer Rex? Ripley's a gamer? Or does he play that Atari? Play some adventure? Or Yar's Revenge or something? Some Pong? I mean, I could play some Asteroids. Dated, broski. You can find those at the retro arcades now. Mr. Aaron shakes his head and his eyes land back on me. Someone writing for this mod. Reed is like me for real, for real. He's literally me, guys. Your turn, Anon. Everybody else shared. Now you. Let me guess. Illusion of choice. What do I say? I can't just tell him about my forums. He'd put me on a list for sure. Anime is off the table too. Mr. Earn's the last person I'd reveal my power level to. What about... well, dirt bikes. Dirt bikes. Reed is a Reddit mod. My favorite character in Snoot is Trish, surprisingly. That's usually like a black sheep right there for a choice. Not to be too on the nose there. Everybody goes quiet and stares at me wide-eyed as if I just kicked an orphan. Dirt bikes? Like, actually? Well, yeah. Back in Rock Bottom's how I got around. My parents wouldn't let me dare drive the family car. One of my neighbors was getting rid of one, so I took it off his hands and learned to fix it up a bit. I mean, at least keep it working. I dislike the curious stares they're all giving me, but I feel ready to jump out of my skin. I feel so sorry for you. Trish gets better with context from the bonus chapters. Yeah, a little bit. Keep up the pace, Anon. Considering I didn't really hang out with a lot of people, I had plenty of time to tweak and fiddle with all the parts and learn how it worked. An approving smile spreads across Mr. Aaron's beak. I pegged you wrong, Anon. Mechanical work is an admirable hobby. Holy shit, a compliment! After a bit more leisure away from fishing, we all reconvene on the boat for lunch. Fang's mom planned ahead and made everyone's luncheons, save for mine. Apparently, Fang made mine special. Mr. Aaron is suspicious about what she had put in it, but we're both relieved when it seems to be a normal lunch. When Amber's already born. What? Sandwich, little bag of chips, an apple, the works. Even a small note that read, Mom said it would be cute to write you a note. I don't know what to put here, but pretend it says something raunchy to make Dad freak out. She even wrote out the little tarot emoji too. Sadly, lunch goes a lot quicker than I was hoping for, and Mo starts passing out our rods. Now that lunch is settled, let's get back to business. A little better, at least Trish admits to being wrong, unlike a certain red parasaur people keep simping over. Freaking Mia. First one to reel in. El Gigante. Gets to decide how I grill him up. I'm thinking Cajun. The rod Mr. Aaron lent me finally works its way back into my hands. There's a big problem, however. I don't know what Mo did while handling it, but the line is tangled and knotted to hell. Mo, what happened to my rod? I set it down for an hour. Was that? I don't know, kid. Something must have happened to it, I guess. Yeah, it's all tangled. I can't even turn the reel. This is an issue. How the hell do I fix something like this? I just learned how to fucking tie a knot. Something wrong, Anon? I turn around and see that Mr. Aaron is hovering behind me. He eyes the rod as Mo and Nazer's words of wisdom from last night drift into my mind. Ask for help, obviously, but we'll save anyways. Concrete shoes in the bottom of the ocean won't be enough. I hang my head and pass my rod off to the hulking tarot before me. Yeah, my line's all fucked up, but I don't know how to fix it. Mr. Aaron grabs the rod and squints at the tangle of knots. How in the hell did this happen? Oh, he's actually got a face palm. I don't think this was shown in, like, normal Snoot game. I don't know. I set it down and went swimming. When Mo handed it back to me, it was a tangled mess. Mr. Aaron snorts. I bet Mo messed it up when he was putting in the tougher lines. Raptor Jesus knows he has a massive blind spot on that snout of his. I'm glad you brought this to my attention, though. It takes a real man to admit he is in need of a helping hand. I'm genuinely surprised that he's helping me. Mo and Nazer were right. If I just open up and not worry as much, maybe I stand a chance in bonding with the guy. Mr. Aaron holds out the rod again and shows me the reel Mr. Aaron holds out the rod again and shows me the reel with the mangle of line. We gain dad points. Look at his hand, bro. It's the size of one of... God, Zen, you're so fucking thirsty. Don't want to interrupt Armored. Does anyone in chat know the name of this mod? Want to give it a go myself. It's called Fishing Trip. You can find it on Snoot Club. The Snoot Club Discord. Wow, we got a super detailed picture here, guys. See the knot? At some point, Moev may have accidentally snapped the line with one of his claws. The reel began to unwind and got tangled in itself. Like when you put on a pair of headphones in your pocket and they come out all messed up after like 3 minutes. I suppose. He gets to work quickly, pulling and snipping the line in different spots with a pocket knife I didn't know he had. Wait, am I wrong, Porku? We're not going to be horny on Maine, okay? See here? Before I cut the line, I loosened up the drag to get the line out from underneath the gear. Once that's set and done, I can cut the line close to the spool and pull out most of the mess. The rest is going to take a bit to pull off, but with a show of force, we can clear it. I was actually able to follow as he showed me what he's doing, but the terminology he's using is still alien gobbledygook. I was trying to find a Discord of this. Look up Snoot Club. Should I just give you guys the Snoot Club? Someone post the Snoot Club Discord. The mod should be in the show and tell section. That's where like all the mods and fanfictions are. You'll find them in there. I need that 18 plus roll though. In mine? Are you 18? I mean, with all the freaking horny on Maine you do, man. You are definitely thirsty. It might look like a nightmare to figure out, but it's actually a simple fix. As long as you got a sharp blade, you can cut through most of it. It's weird how much of these parts are reminding me of fishing trips with my father-in-law. This mod is literally for you. I am 25. All right. Give me 1 month, man. You'll see me there. Yeah, no problem. Well, just wait it out. You got a knife, son? Of course I do. I gotta have protection when dealing with the tweakers back home in Skin Row. A look of concern washes over his beak, and he turns away after handing me back the fixed rod. 25, that's quite the age. I'm older, though. Dude, I'm like in my early 30s. I don't sound like it, but goddamn, I feel old. I'm not comfortable in my own skin anymore. Let's get set up. With the clouds rolling in, maybe the fish will be more responsive. He's quiet all of a sudden, too. He sounds sad. Is everything all right, Mr. Aaron? You need to get paid for this, Porcupine. Well, I do have a throne thing. I don't have my channel monetized at all. I'm 29. We're all millennials and old zoomers here, aren't we? I mean, I've been thinking about like linking up like a coffee or something. I don't know. We'll figure out monetization down the road. It's just I'm not too concerned about it. He waves me off. Fine, let's get to fishing. Porku is currently the second person with the most views relating to Wani. Really? 31, you don't feel old at 30, it's at 31. Well, I got a lot of body problems, man. I've let myself waste away. I'm that 31-year-old that just carries a tiny razor knife and that multi-tool. Not that interesting, to be honest. Star Wars reference for real. I am your father. Maybe I said something and fucked up again. Nobody else seems to be acting any different, though. I cast my rod out to the water, followed by the others, save for Reed. He's walking towards us with jerky movements. Ow. Reed, you look pinker than normal. Oh, he's been tanning, isn't he? He got sunburnt. Yeah, man. Are you okay? Fine as wine, my guy. Straight cap on. Reed, did you get a sunburn? Part of me wants to gloat, but honestly, I feel pity for the guy. Maybe. He looks away. Can you check my back for me, bros? Nazer face palms. Yeah, I can. Turn around. I snag my bag from its spot from in the shade from by the driver's seat. Reed turns around and removes his shirt. Another plump. It looks the same. I mean, there's a typical stripes and such I expected to see, but I'm not entirely sure what a sunburn on a raptor would look like. We immune to sunburns for real. Read 10 minutes later. Only one way to find out, I guess. Slap him on the back, buddy. Just give him a good slap. We could just slap his back, dude. Okay, there is one thing I gotta do. We're gonna save, or we're gonna come back. There's that whip. Reed yelps and arches his back away from my hand. Oh, dude! Sorry, Reed. I think I've got something to help, though. Carf? Aloe. That works, too. Thanks, homebro Leo. Wait, what's Zen doing? What is Zen doing? Don't let the old man in, guys. Clint Eastwood was right. I like the cut of your G. Oh, God. Or I like your cut G. I'm not rubbing Reed's back down, so I hand him off a spare bottle. Alright. We'll go back. Oh wait, no, we're not saving, buddy. We're not saving. No. Yeah, I don't care about him. Oh, poke. Is it just the same thing? Ow, dude. It's the illusion of choice, guys. Sorry, Reed. I think I got something to help you, though. Hey, let's skip. It's the same. It's the same. It doesn't matter. Wow, fix your mod. That's not cool. So the weekend hasn't been a total loss. Fishing is actually pretty fun. It's tranquil and gives me plenty of peace and quiet to think. Every once in a while, the occasional joke lets me know that everyone else is still there. I still don't fully get why Mr. Earn brought me along. I know he's looking to get an angle on me, but I feel like our personalities are just way too different. The illusion of free choice. Apart from that, though, the fishing trip has been interesting, from the talks with Nazer, Reed, and Moe, all the way to the chance interaction with Spears. It's a strange dynamic we have, and to be honest, I feel really comfortable. More so than I did at the start of the year, at least. I've made friends, more than I thought I'd ever have, and I even have some semblance of a family again. I wonder how long it'll be until I screw it up. Let's not dwell on that too long. Gotta focus on fishing! Still haven't caught any fish yet, though. Maybe a nibble, but I'm pretty sure that was just King Rex. At this point, everyone else has caught at least one. Reed even has three. So what gives? Do the fish know I'm an amateur? Anon. Maybe I just gotta change up my stance. Or maybe my cast. Or maybe the fish just hate me. Anon. Maybe I'll snake some of Reed's not carf, but pretty sure it's carf fish bait. Anon! I jump and nearly lose my rod to the murky depths as I spin to address Mr. Aaron. Yeah? You do that a lot? Do what? Oh, he was caught talking to himself. Talk to yourself. Mumbling, fuck me running. Deflect, deflect, deflect. Just singing a song, lyrical stuff. Why are you lying to me? Oh, the music cut. Uh-oh. Answer me, son. At this moment, I feel very small. Mr. Aaron's eyes bore holes into my face. Before I became a commissioner, I was a detective. I can read people as if they were open books. You make it much too easy. Speak your mind. Well, we gotta be honest. So what we're gonna do, we're gonna save over this because it doesn't matter. We're gonna speak our mind. Why not? It's the giant fish there. Oh, we're talking about El Gigante or something. I can't stand to look him in the eye. My voice sounds quiet when I speak. Yeah, it's kind of personal. I zone out and think. Sometimes my thoughts are vocalized. Before he can speak up, I answer the question he was probably going to ask. It's how Fang found out I liked her. She caught on pretty quickly. Mr. Earn's expression softens and he sighs. I figured as much. I'm just glad to hear it from you. I understand your nervousness more than you know. A heavy hand lands on my shoulder. I had to grow out of that myself. On a lot of jobs I went on as deputy, I would mumble to myself. Just like you do now, except it was more angry sounding, I suppose. I remember the first time meeting Sam's parents. They always thought I was strange because of it. Mr. Earn mumbled once too? He's probably just trying to relate to me, right? He's literally me, guys! Just like Lucy, Sam caught on quickly. She thought it was... He went quiet. I could still see his beak moving. Cute. Adorable. Endearing. He shrugs. It was because of her that her parents looked past it. He sighs again. That was a long and awkward conversation. Nevertheless, I will do you the same kindness that her parents did me and ignore it. We are kindred souls, I guess. Mr. Earn casts his line out, and I do the same. That we are. It's been a couple of hours since Mr. Earn and I had that awkward talk. We haven't had much luck with the fish, and we're planning on heading back home tomorrow morning. Oh, we're getting to the end of the mod, guys. Oh, boy. There's, like, three endings here, so we're gonna get one of them. I'm sure some of you guys who already played the mod could probably help me out here, right? We'll probably dish it all out in one go. Because I feel like it'd be super short of a stream if we just hunted for endings. Specifically. If he discovers what Anon's been doing to Fang, it's Jover. The boat is silent as we sway and bob on the water. The strange quiet is only being offset by the occasional breeze. Any luck, boys? Nope. Negatory. Nah, bruh. There's a slight tug on my line. Wait. Everybody turns to me. Tug, tug. I reflexively yank backwards. My line snags on something, and I'm nearly thrown headfirst into the water on the return pole. We got two, looks like it. I wouldn't know. Holy shit! I struggle to hold the beast on my end. On the end of my line as everyone rushes over to me. They're all shouting incoherently as I yank back with all my strength of my lanklet arms can muster. I feel a weight lifted out from me as Mr. Earn wraps his hand around the rod. Soon Nazer and Mo do the same. Start reeling it in, Anon! I can only offer a strained nod as my right hand reaches for the paddle thing. I crank it. I crank it to Snoot Boru. Forward as best as I can as the rod whips back and forth. Even at our combined might, this demon fish is giving us all a run for our money. I'm already breaking a sweat. Slowly but surely, I reel in the line. From on the water, there's a splash as the white tail fin breaks the surface. Ooh, nice art. I like how there's fear in even Ripley's eyes, dude. Crank that, soldier boy. I like how derpy the fish looks. Alright. It's... El Gigante! I can't believe it. I got it! Not yet, we don't. Let's get this bastard. With all of us working in tandem, we yank and strain against El Gigante's might. Nazer, get the net ready! On it! El Gigante gets closer and closer to the side of the boat. I can feel my heart thundering in my throat as we lift the beast's barbed head from the murky depths. Goddamn, that's a big fish. It gasps and thrashes as Nazer dips the net underneath. It's fucking huge! At least 6 feet long. I've never seen a fish like this before. Snow White and spiky fins. We all heave to get it safely under the net, but El Gigante has other plans. Another violent flop, and the line snaps for a third time. All of us save for Nazer fall backwards onto our asses. Nazer holds fast to the net and scoops El Gigante in before he can make a dive for the water. I can only watch as I struggle to my feet in the mess of tangled arms and legs. Nazer's eyes go wide as he lets out an alarmed squawk as the weight of the fish causes him to fall over to the side of the boat with net still in hand. He tried his best to fight the momentum, but the odd angle his body was at made it hard for him to keep balance. Nazer! Man overboard! What was that sound effect? What the fuck? What the fuck, man? I stumble to the side and dive in after him, grabbing Nazer by the ankle before he disappears from view. I heave him up and get his head above water. He coughs and sputters, but seems to be okay. Thank God. Damn it, I lost the net. I make out three snouts poking over the side of the railing. Nazer, Anon, you all right? There goes the fresh coat of aloe I slathered on my head. Sound effect, yeah. What the fuck? That was from Scout TF2. We're okay. We lost the net, though. Sorry, Dad. Kind of hard to swim and hold onto a fish at the same time. Nazer and I are hauled onto the shit and brought beach towels to help us dry off. I cannot believe our luck. The line snapping once is believable, even twice, but three times? Three? And all in the course of a weekend. It's as if the stars are aligned and told us no. No fish. Frowny face. He literally put the frowny face on his face. What the fuck, man? What is this weird mod? Drink break. I see we're at 69 views. Very nice. I mean, we all saw it, right? We know for certain now that El Gigante is real. Hey, it worked. That was my win for the week. Biggest budget cut. There you go, Anon. Story you could tell around the campfire. Our departure time was fast approaching now, so after this last encounter, we had no choice but to throw in the towel if we wanted to get back to Volcadera Bluffs in time. Prized fish or no, I guess we didn't get the good ending. At some point, Ripley pulled me aside while the others grabbed some refreshments. Anon, I want you to know that despite the hang-ups, I think this weekend went adequately. Wait, really? I know I come off strong, I can get tunnel vision when fishing at times. And while you have quite a lot to learn, I can teach you on our next fishing trip. That is, if you want to take along. I feel a wide smile spread across my face. Ripley mirrors it. I'ma go shower. All right, Lemon. That doesn't sound half bad. The ride back was surprisingly uneventful, besides the occasional joke we all chuckled at. Open fields blended into the countryside, and eventually back into the urban sprawl, we all called home. We got the dad. The rising sun shined out over the oceanside as we took our exit off the freeway. We bade Reed farewell back at the lake. He had crammed his hammock back in his van and had taken off a bit before us. I made sure to give him a final thank you for his help. My wandering mind helps to speed things along in the car. Before long, we're back at the Aaron household. Portal music again. We better fucking see Fang. We gotta boop the snoot. Here we are, gentlemen. Home again, jiggity jig. We all climbed out and began unloading our gear and the fish we brought back. Mo offers me a hearty pat on the back after he says his farewells to Mr. Aaron and Azer. You did good this weekend, kid. I can't wait to bring you into the Dynamo's pizza family. Oh yeah, the job. I almost forgot about that. Wait, that's Persona music? What a mod. As Mo heads off to his comically tiny car, Nazer passes by. What'd you think, Anon? Pretty good. Never done anything like that before, but I'm genuinely glad I went. I'm sure Dad is too. I mean, at least he seems to be in a good mood. You can never be certain with him, though. Anyways, I'm gonna get inside. I gotta call Naomi and fill her in on the trip. He sags slightly. Every last detail. Are you gonna tell him about hugging and kissing and stuff? Good luck, bro. Pizza Mo's mod. Well, didn't they already have a Mo's mod out there? I started watching a little bit of that, but I haven't finished it. With a final nod, he leaves. I turn my attention to the garage where a certain goth GF is leaning. There she is, boys. Fang is patiently waiting for me. She has her arms crossed over her chest and a smile on her face. Do what to her? What? So, how did it go? Honestly, I don't know what you were complaining about. It was fun. Fang scoffs and rolls her eyes. Good, you can take my spot from now on then. What about Dad? Her eyes drift open to the Tarot Patriarch as he pretends to ignore our rather loud conversation. Pretty good, actually. I think we even bonded. Fang's eyes go wide. No, really? I offer a nod to her overly dramatic response. We both laugh. I'm just glad you're back in one piece. I missed you. You were only gone for like a day and a half. Oh, there it is. We get to hug the pterodon. I don't care. She wraps her arms and wings around me in a tight hug. I can feel her long snout rub my cheek. Over her shoulder, I could see Mr. Aaron enter the house with bags weighing down his arms. There, the father's always watching. He stops and looks back at us in the middle of our embrace. I tense for a second, but it dissipates when I swear a small smile. It was only for a second, though. Back home to depression. Post-fishing depression here. Now I find myself back in my crummy apartment on Skin Row. I miss that bed at the cabin. The mattress is 1,000 times better than this cardboard I find myself splayed across now. Man, the more I look back on it, the more I keep thinking about El Gigante. And the lake. And the guys in general. I can't believe my reclusive ass is admitting this, but I had a blast. It was awkward at times, sure. Tense and rocky, too. I thought for sure I was going to end up at the bottom of the lake. In reality, Mr. Aaron just wanted to better understand me. And I guess deep down I wanted to understand him, too. A guy his size makes a better friend than an enemy. Not to mention Nazer and the others. I feel as if I'd grown closer to every single one of them. I have a weird warmth in my gut that I haven't felt since I was a kid. It makes me feel happy. Content. Like I belong. The weekend has had its ups and downs, sure, but I think in the end we all came out in a net positive. Also a net negative because we lost our net. And tomorrow it's back to school. Prom is fast approaching, the end of the school year along with it. Fang hug is the best end. Maybe even another fishing trip or two. I guess only time will tell. I'm actually looking forward to it. Play through the other endings for a special treat. Replay, return the menu. Alright, we will it doesn't even say what ending we got, guys. Like, what the fuck? What is your mod if you can't title them right? Thursday afternoon, where I skip until we get to our first choice, which we will say we will meet at the lake. Coincidence might be a better route, that way Mr. Aaron won't know that I invited Reed behind his back. Can you meet us at Lake Sulaco? Reed coughs and snorts again. That's like the lake I lost the costume at, bro. Did you follow me out there? He lowers his voice to a whisper. Are you an alien? Is that why you're bald? Just kidding. Right. What? What? No, that's the lake Mr. Aaron's cabin is on. Just pretend like it's a coincidence that we meet up there. I got a feeling if I bring you along without telling Feng's dad, he won't be too happy. Do you know the route to the lake? Well, first you're going to want to get in your car. Then you're going to want to start your car. A lot of people get halfway to the lake and then realize they forgot to start the car. What? Reed belts out a wheezy laugh. Relax, bro. It's just a bit of lake humor. He's lost me. Sure, let's just meet at the lake after school, okay? You got it, hombre. Oh, wait, before you go. Reed reaches his hand out from under his stall. Can you snag me some TP? So this is probably all the same, so skip. As I approach Fang's house, I could see Mr. Aaron is outside already with Mo in their bags. He's in the process of loading up his SUV. And there's Fang! Now we get to see Fang, guys, because we don't bring Reed along. We get to hug the pterodon. The pterodactyl. When she spots me, a small smile comes to her beak. Hey, dweeb, ready to spend some quality time with my old man? We start with a hug. She wraps her arms and wings around me in a hug, which I graciously return. Oh, it's a sad hug. Not in the slightest. Have you ever been fishing with him? He's peeking out in the corner. I can feel her dad's eyes on me as we embrace. But I'm conflicted on ending the hug or continuing to hold her in hopes that she'll protect me from his wrath. The romance was palpable in this mod. Not to mention her downy soft hug helps to melt my stress away. Sadly, she pulls away and shakes her head. Middle finger. Not a chance. I can't stand sitting in silence out on a boring lake. This is your hell now, not mine. Gee, thanks, Fang. She scoffs. I can still see Mr. Aaron's cold gaze on me out in the corner of my eye. You'll be fine. He knows I like you, so he won't do anything too bad, probably. We hug the gator. Mean terror. It's time we go fight death. You're not helping. I'd rather be at home playing Rock Ring. The door to the house opens, and I can see Nazer step out with his bags. He exchanges a few words with his father before loading everything under his arms into the trunk of the SUV. Hey, Anon, ready to head out? We leave in 5 minutes. Did Dad tell you to split us up? She says it flatly, and I can tell by the way Nazer's shoulders droop that she was on the snoot. Was it that obvious? I can read you like an open book, dork. She flicks his beak and laughs. I nod along to answer his original question and to get them to stop bickering before it can begin. Oh yeah, Fang can't stand silence. Happens to my dad too. Which is a musician too, huh? I got my bag right here. Extra aloe for the chrome dome as well. Damn the sun and the way it scorches my bald ass head. Nazer nods and gestures to the trunk. You could toss it back there with the rest. Now another hug. As I nod, Fang gives me one last hug goodbye. I'll see you Sunday night, okay? If I'm not dead. She laughs as she pulls away and heads towards the house, turning back just before she goes through the door to give me a comforting smile, melting away some of my concern. So often does your dad do these trips? Fishing trips? About once every other month. I've only been on a couple. Usually it's just him, or him and Mo. Is there enough room at the cabin for all four of us? Nazer looks down and rubs the back of his neck. there's only three rooms, so chances are we'll have to share. I shrug. I'm used to sleeping in a crappy twin bed, so a wide open floor will be a welcome change of pace. Alright, everybody load up! I want to get to the lake with enough time to cast some lines out before nightfall. His voice is enough to shake me from the conversation. Laser gives me a pat on the shoulder and heads to the car. Just a heads up, I'm not sitting behind Mo. Or, I didn't know we were calling seats. So this part's probably the same. We finish loading up and get into the SUV. It's pretty nice and still has that new car smell too that we skip. Oh, this is new, I guess. You don't strike me as a man who gets out much. I nearly jump as Fang's dad slows his pace to match mine. I would have preferred if we'd just exist in silence with each other. Was this his attempt at small talk? No, sir. Only real time I got out here was on the trails back home. Trails? I nod as I remember rock bottom and all the dirt trails that ran like back roads through the woods. Hello, I wish I could make it earlier, but it is what it is. I'll be catching up, though. Alright, Doggo. Glad you're here nonetheless. I'm pretty sure a part of me, they were exclusively used by moonshiners. Drug dealers. Yeah, whenever I wanted some peace and quiet, I used to walk them, which was a lot. Those punching sound effects. Yeah, they really like their sound effects in this mod. Mr. Earn doesn't respond. I thought it was because of pity, but as I look back to him, I can see his eyes are squinting at an approaching van, and it's gonna be Reed! The windows are fogged up, and I can feel the deep thrum of heavy bass music in my chest as it approaches. Scirocco. The van stops, and a window rolls down to reveal Reed. Shit, I told him to meet us here. Whoa, Mr. Aaron? Anon, what are you guys doing up here? What a surprise! He speaks in the most phoned-in tone I've ever heard. Reed, what are you doing here? Like, I come up here all the time to clear my head, you know? Right. I nervously look between Reed and Mr. Aaron. It's clear the cop isn't buying the druggie's story. God, what was I thinking? This just keeps getting worse. Anyways, what are you guys doing up here? And why'd you bring Anon? Mr. Aaron side-eyes me. I do my best to avoid the prosecuting glare. Weekend fishing excursion? Oh damn, really? You mind if I tag along? I was actually planning to do some fishing myself. To both mine and Mr. Aaron's surprise, he produces a well-worn rod from one of the seats behind him. Mr. Aaron face palms. Beak palms? Sigh. He rubs the bridge of his no-snout face. Reed offers a quick wink in my direction. Holy shit, my stoner angel. Fine, but not a word from you about anything medicinal, understood? You got it, Chief. He offers a sluggish salute. And with that, Reed parks his van and follows along behind us. Is this all the same? It's only the second time I've seen Mr. Aaron genuinely smile as he gazes upon his boat. There she is, boys, the SS Hiddle. The boat is decent size, if I had to guess, at least 30 feet. On the stern is a somewhat scratch-out sign. Well, I could tell it once said SS Hiddle. The first S of the and the Idle of Hiddle are both scuffed beyond legibility, leaving a big shit in front of my face. Judging by the boat's state, the name wasn't too far off. I could feel the weight of a hand on my shoulder. What do you think, Anon? While he's technically asked a question, I feel he will only accept one answer. Well... Ah, the shit! Just as I remember her. The shit. I could hear Mr. Aaron grumble as his claws dig into my shoulder. Just get on the boat. The motor sputters and whines as Mr. Aaron keys the ignition. Laser awkwardly scrambles against the dock. Yeah, this is all the same, isn't it? Yep. All right, so does this one. We'll go with the flaccid looking one. Lol. Lamau. I reach my hand into the gravity lure, root around the box. I can feel my fingers brush one of the barbed hooks. Yeah, this is all the same. All those fucking hits, man. All right, not causing an accident. I'm not touching that wheel. Mr. Aaron? He stops and turns back to me with the rods in hand. What is it? I really don't feel comfortable driving this boat. I don't want to risk crashing it. He closes his eyes and puts a hand over his beak. Give me back the keys. He grumbles as he swipes the keys back from me before heading over to the wheel. Mo, get off your ass and go rig the lines. Show Wayne on how to do it. What was that? Bo squeezes his way towards us from where he had been in the bow. Mr. Aaron sighs once more. You should have driven. I know you. We should have driven, but we're going to go for the bad ending. We're going to do all the bad choices or choices we haven't done. I know it's a good option to drive. We'll do the best ending after this. Just don't backseat right now. I said, show Anon how to rig the lines. I'm taking us into deeper waters. Ah, sure thing, Rip. Mo puts a small hand on my shoulder and gently pushes me towards the back of the boat. Come on, Anon, let me show ya. And we skip. To say Mo's lessons stuck would be a lie. He had droned on about the finer points of setting up a rod. My mind began to wander. I believe I made the right choice when it came to dealing with Mr. Aaron. I stood my ground, and he actually listened. Ooh, I'm skipping this. What do you mean? Oh, you never did this one before? Backseat skip put into dino horny jail. I'm a shower in the meantime. Didn't you already shower, Lemon, or am I thinking of someone else? My God. People are more than thirsty. They require a whole ass shower. I see Nazer come up from below deck and glance towards Mr. Aaron before approaching us. Oh, this is new. Oh, great. More helping hands. Dad looks pissed. What'd you do, Anon? Me? I feel Mo's hand slap my back and nearly send me overboard. I'm just not interested. Okay. I see how it is, Lemon. Anon here seems to have troubles with the whole Aaron family, huh? Not true. Mrs. Aaron likes me. I think. What did I do? I'ma watch the bad end later. Alright. From the tone of old Rip's voice, he's frustrated. I can tell it's because he's had that tone since he showed up to his house. If he hates me so much, why go to all this effort to bring me along on this trip? I'd rather be playing Rock Ring anyways. Wait, are you saying I'm the one who's causing him stress? On the nose, kid, but not on the way you thinks. Some of y'all are down bad. I am too. We're all down bad, but we just hide it better than others. He can be really awkward when it comes to conversations that take more than a few words. Especially when dealing with emotions, or bonding. Nazer shivers as if reminiscing over his own experiences with Mr. Aaron. They like to hit Anon a lot, especially with those sound effects. Yeah, this is definitely not Caveman's work, that's for sure. He's a no-nonsense type of guy, capiche? And so then how do I get on his good side? The pair look at each other for a second, then burst out laughing. Kid, Ripley don't have a good side. He's usually either contemplative or sullen. Mo waves my question off. I'd be more down bad for a good coffee right now. Listen, we'll talk more about this later when we get a little more space. I hope whatever Mo has planned gets me on good terms with Mr. Aaron. I'm not a big fan of the icy stares that have been thrown my way. Alright, is this same old, same old? Boat sways gently in the calm waters, all of us taking the moment to relax and cast our lines. As our cast lines sit behind us, yep. I wasn't about to screw up a second time. Mr. Aaron made steering the boat look easy. How hard could it be? Hopefully those words don't come back to bite me in the ass. So now we're forced to drive. The boat crawls through the water as the sky darkens. For the first time I got the lake, I feel at peace. I don't know. I have zero idea. Do it yourself, pussy. I think I've got it. Hell yeah, I do. Mr. Earn gives me a small nod. Good man. And off he goes. With that, he left me to do my duty. This has to be similar to parallel parking, right? Well, same old, same old. Alright, this time we'll talk to Mo. I'm gonna go check out on the basement. When will I get another chance like this? I slowly head down the stairs as they groan under my weight. Rip, is that you? You must have heard me. It's just me. Anon, come on down, you punk. Come have a drink with old Mo. I cautiously descend, half expecting to see Ripley waiting for me despite Mo's question. We even get a little art piece. We got RoboCop, Raptor Cop, Reservoir Dogs. What is this in the back? I can't tell. A little jar. There's a bottle of piss here. Like, they got a dedicated piss bottle. Like, what the fuck, man? Ripley, what are you doing? I'm relieved when I reach the landing to find only Mo. Couldn't sleep? I was... No, I couldn't get comfortable. I get you. I had to grab something to loosen me up. Old Rip keeps his liquor all up here in his cabin. He snickers as he reaches below the oak countertop and grabs a pair of glasses. I take a seat on one of the barstool chairs as Mo pours out an amber liquid from the decanter into our glasses. That jar, yeah, the piss jar. Keep that jar away from Bear Grylls. Not even we are that thirsty. He tops mine off with some name brand cola and gives me a wink. Just in case Rip comes down, don't want him to think he's dipping into his stash with me. Thanks, Mo. No prob, kid. So what's got your mind wandering so late at night? What doesn't? I thought Mr. Aaron was... I cut myself off there. Mo is good friends with Mr. Aaron. Do I really want to spill my concerns to him? You thought Rip was gonna kill you, huh? Yeah, I have no idea why he dragged me out here with you guys. This has gotta be some sort of intimidation tactic, right? Mo laughed, almost holding back a tear. If Rip wanted you dead, you would have disappeared a long time ago. You ought to seize him when he catches the fish. Wham! Right here. Mo points to his forehead. Gulp. Does he do that to all of his? Flashback to his living room with the prey mounted on his wall. Definitely a lot of TF2 references, yeah? Jurati. Can't imagine how he convinced Mrs. Aaron to let him put him up there. You don't get out much, do you, kid? I think I've played Crocella's Big Game Hunter once. Mo sighs. Listen, kid, you're overthinking this whole thing. What do you mean? Old Rip didn't bring you out here to kill you or even scare you. That's all in your head. Mo takes a sip from his drink, and I mirror him. God, that's strong. He wants to get you to know you better, you dope. See how you think. What goes on in your head, outside of being just some young, dumb, and horny teen? I rub the back of my neck and stare into the ripples of my drink. I mean, how many times has he chased you out of Lucy's room? A couple of times. That's just a boys' trip. A boys' trip with Rip. He knocks back his drink and sets his glass back on the table. How's the wife? So how do I get on his good side, then? I feel like I'm screwing everything up. I feel a small hand rest on my shoulder from across the bar. When I look up, I can actually see Moses' eyes past his squint. You ain't screwing nothing up, kid. You're just nervous is all. I know Rip feels the same way, too. A pair of kindred souls used to. What is he talking about? Me and him? How? Use it, well, You're both awkward, especially when it comes to showing how you feel. Know what I'm saying? Maybe. I nurse my drink as Mo drums his fingers expectantly. I feel my gears turning, getting jammed, and then moving again. Okay, yeah, maybe I'm a bit. A bit? Kid, you really don't get out much. You're acting like I haven't been watching you since you stumbled into my joint looking for a joint. Or wait, looking for a joint. I can see it deeps in ya, you wanna say, but you suck at expressing it. Since when was Mo a therapist? I slowly twirl the dark drink in my hands, trying to think of a response as I take another sip. I can't believe this, but maybe Mo is right. Don't beat yourself up over it, kid. Rip's the same way. Ripley? The same man who's threatened to bludgeon me to death when I first met him? Or at least implied it? I don't know, Mo. Did he tell you about when we met each other? Mo laughs again. Then I stood on the table and whoosh, I could have sworn he pissed his pants. Mo waves his hands and reenacts the event. His Ripley impression is not necessarily good by any means. His voice drops to a gentler tone after pouring more booze into his glass and taking a sip. He got all worried after he told me about it, asking me if I did the right thing. Like he was worried he scared you too bad and that you wouldn't come back and all. He says to me that Lucy never brought home a boy in a romantic sense. Didn't know how to address it till you walked through his front door. He was such a bundle of nerves that he even looked up your name on public records, checked your history.
He did what?
That sounds like a violation of my privacy? He did it out of fear. I'm telling you, kid, he might not show it, but he is really trying for Lucy. Wow, this game is so relatable. It's the mod. It's not the game, it's the mod. I don't know what to say. You don't have to say anything, kid. Just know. He dons a serious gaze. You two's peas in a pod, and this is all. Give him a chance to really try and bond with him, and you two's will hit it off. He's already impressed him once before. I know you can do it again. That was a lot to unpack. I'm pretty sure he broke the law when he looked up my record. But he did it for Fang. He does care. He just shows it in an odd and potentially illegal way. But he cares. Maybe he is like me. If I were a scary-looking tarot cop and overbearing dad, I'd probably do the same kind of things. I guess I could put in more effort into understanding him. Alright, Mo. Come tomorrow, I'll try again with Mr. Aaron. Hopefully, armed with the information I got tonight, I can better communicate with him. Let's get a drink. Oof. I feel warm and fuzzy after that talk, but I'm pretty sure it's just the cola mixed with alcohol. That drink went down a lot smoother towards the end there. That, and I felt like I was going to have a stroke if I heard any more Moe's stereotypical Italian Bostonian accent. Yeah, well, try reading it, buddy. Turns out I was down there talking to Moe a lot longer than I thought. By the time I crawled back up to the stairs to our room, the sliding glass door is closed again and Nazer is fast asleep. I kind of feel bad I missed my chance to talk to him, but I can acquire tomorrow. I'm failing behind the mods like this one because I've been trying to finish the ending 3 in original game. You should always just look up a guide to get there. I'm surprised people don't post like Snoot game guides to like the Wani Steam page. I feel like that'd be a given. I crawl back into my side of the bed, making sure to leave a safe 2-ish feet between us, and drift off to sleep. Alright, is this gonna be the same? Yeah, it's gonna be the same, so we'll skip it. Oh wait, no, it's not. I stir in the comfy bed and find myself in now, still fading in and out of consciousness. I snuggled up to me as a familiar warm presence. I gently massage the smooth scales under my hand as I kiss Fang's neck. Hey, this is all the same. Why am I forced to see it again? Okay, no, I'm not. It's just the game being retarded. All right, we'll cover for Reed like a bro. I'm not letting Reed sink for this. He's a bro. We never even get to learn what Reed's punishment was. Or at least I think I have an idea of what happened. Come on, Anon, think of something fast. A few days ago, I spotted some guys wearing St. Hammond high jackets sneaking out of the school with the costume. I thought it was part of some dumb prank war that somebody already knew what was happening, so I didn't say anything about it. I mean, I haven't exactly been here long. I don't know how this kind of stuff works. I can see Spears' broad shoulders sag as he runs a hand through his hair. I'm sorry, Principal Spears. I should have known better. I didn't think they would dump it all the way up here. He puts a hand up to stop me. It's all right, Anon. I wasn't prepared for a senior prank war starting so early. I also shouldn't have assumed so quickly that Reed had something to do with it. No doubt that King Rex will take some time to find, but hopefully it won't take too much out of my day. He shakes his head and starts his boat back up. My wife would kill me if it takes more than a few hours. I promised I'd take her out to dinner tonight. He stands up straight and nods to me. In any case, I appreciate your assistance, Anon. Sure thing. With that, he speeds off in the other direction. I feel a hand on my shoulder, and I turn to see Nazer offer a small nod. Yo, guys, is Spears gone? Well, no, I didn't want to do that. It's just the same stuff. All right, Sparrow. Everyone goes quiet before bursting out laughing. Shit. Oh, this is where the line gets tangled. So I'm gonna solo it. I shake my head. I can figure this one out. It's just a tangle. How hard could it be? Plus, I might even be able to impress Mr. Aaron. It's all right. I think I got it. Quick work of my young and dexterous fingers as I loop my way through the tangles and knots of high-strength line shows just how competent I am, which is absolutely not at all. In fact, somehow my entire left hand ends up tied to the rod. I really overestimated myself. Shit. I hear Mr. Aaron sigh. Damn it, Anon. Don't worry, I think I got it. Just give me the damn rod. It's stuck on my hand. He rolls his eyes and pulls out a knife from his pocket. Hold still. Grabs my wrists and gently maneuvers the flat end of the blade between the skin and the line. Here. First, the line comes loose around my wrist and Mr. Aaron nabs the rod. It's not the end of the world to ask for help, son. If you're having issues, don't try to figure it out yourself. You even told us you haven't been fishing before, so what makes you think you can suddenly know how to clear a tangle like that? Oh, geez, guy. He's not wrong, though. I just wanted to do something by myself for once. I can see Mr. Aaron out of the corner of my eye. His shoulders sag as he finishes with the rod. I reach for the net, but he stops me. No, take your rod back. Come on, we're close to the spot. I cast my rod out to the water, followed by the others, save for Reed. He'll slap his back. Too embarrassing. I'd rather not talk about it. It's personal. Why? It's just mumbling. His eyes narrow on me. You got something to hide? No, I'd just rather not talk about it. It's a personal thing. I turn back to my line and see the taro sag. Yeah. All right, Anon. Wow. That was it. That was the segment. That's sad. Kind of feel bad for shutting him down like that, but there's no way I'd talk to him about something as personal as my mumbling. Detective or not, he doesn't need to know about every aspect of my life. Fang finding out was embarrassing enough. Welcome back, Lemon. What did I miss? You missed some things. Although that did end up going in my favor. Regardless, the less I have to talk about myself, the better. Meaning less ammo he has to use against me. Looks like he's turned away. How's it going with Dad? I nearly jumped as Nazer shuffles up from my left. Huh? He looks at me expectantly. Well? Oh, good, I guess. Not a lot I want to discuss, you know. Have you tried reaching out to him yet? In a way, I guess. We talked about fishing and stuff, kinda. I think. You think. You think. It's been a couple of hours since Mr. Aaron and I had that awkward talk. We haven't had much luck with the fish, and we're planning on heading back home tomorrow morning. The boat is silent as we sway and bob on the water. The strange quiet is only being offset by the occasional breeze. A yanked fight. With everyone's help, Nazer is able to scoop up the behemoth into the net and heave it into the deck. Wait, we got it? The alabaster flops in defeat as we all work to hold it down. Mr. Aaron reaches into its mouth and removes the hook. How did we get it this time? We were like the biggest pieces of shit ever, and we catch the fish. Shadow King subscribed. Thanks for the sub. I don't think the bad ending will be that bad. I don't know which is worse to find here. The piss jar or the sea jar? Okay. Since it's an Ending 4 spinoff. Well, apparently we caught the fish, guys. So I don't know. I heave him into my arms as best as I can, and we all erupt into a wave of cheers. I did it! I called it El Gigante. How's that for an amateur, huh? Reed nabs the disposable camera. I knew I could do it. Say cheese! Before Reed can snap the picture, El Gigante feels that now is a great time to thrash in my arms. Let me guess, we drop it back into the water. Oof. Now we need revival. His massive tail pimp slaps me across the face with a spiteful amount of force. And it's gone. So much force, in fact, I stumble backwards into the driver's seat. My elbow knocks the throttle. Uh-oh. I forgot to set anchor. The five of us fall backwards as the boat lurches forward and speeds off with no driver. Never mind, it's bad. Did he just throw Girardi as the fish? Hey, David subscribed. Thanks, David. Oh, we are fucked. I'm the first to recover to try and crawl back towards the wheel, but it's too late. The boat runs aground on the sandbar near the island and at the center of the lake. The stern whips to the left and out of the control vessel tips to his side. We're all ejected into the shallows. And my peripherals, I can see El Gigante flop into deeper waters and swim away. Yeah, we fucked up. I hurt. It's the Bullard all over again. God damn it, Anon! My blood runs cold. Oh, fuck. Oh, fuck is right. Look what you've done to my boat. Did it not cross your vacant mind to set the damn anchor? Mr. Aaron stands up from the water and sloshes over to me. He grabs me by the collar of my tank top and stares at me with searing anger. It's concrete time. It's concrete time, guys. My trunks are wet for an entirely different reason now. It looks like Anon needs that piss jar. I'm sorry, Mr. Anon. I fell and hit the throttle. I swear I didn't mean to capsize the boat. You idiot! Do you have any idea how much it's gonna cost me to fix this mess? Any second now, I'm gonna get the memories of this trip beaten clear out of my mind. I knew you were trouble the moment I met you. Oh god, oh god, oh god, I'm gonna die! Now hold on a sec, Rip. It's not Anon's fault. And see the titanic pterodactyl's eyes twitch as he turns his attention to the Tyrannosaurus. Bullshit, you saw what he did. There goes my alarm. Hold on, guys. Turn that off. Nazer stands from the water. The fish hit him in the face, Dad. It was an honest mistake. Ripley snorts as Reed floats by. Anon ain't malicious like that, Mr. A. He wouldn't have tipped your boat over on purpose. Are the rest of you siding him with him now? Anon's a good kid. He just makes mistakes. He's awkward. I mean, at least I try. Come on. I can see Mr. Anon. What am I doing? I can see that Mr. Aaron's shoulders sag. The anger etched on his face is replaced with something else. He mercifully lets go of me and drops me back into the water. So in the bad ending, we just end up in bad relations with the dad, pretty much. One of you clowns find the emergency radio and tell park rangers we have a problem. He trudges out of the water with his shoulders down. I don't know where he plans to go. Mazer approaches me after Mr. Aaron leaves and helps me up. Come on, let's go find the radio. Uncle Mo will start up a fire. I have a bad feeling we're going to be here for a while. I nod wordlessly as we slosh back over to the upturned boat. Oh boy, now it's like tilted. And there goes his relationship with Fang. Yeah, we'll see. Everything is toppled and scattered in the water. Tackle, ice boxes, even the camera's drenched. So, about Dad. Sorry, you didn't deserve that. I should have set the anchor. The boat wouldn't have taken off if I had remembered. Don't beat yourself up too bad. You saw the shit. It was, well, it represented its name well. I hear sloshing behind me as Nazer works his way into the cabin below deck. Everything's on its side, the cupboards and other doors hanging open from above, and the carpet underneath sagged into the ground. Water has also leaked into the inner cabin as well. The emergency kit is kept in the bathroom. Thinking, reach it? I can try. Should be a radio in there. Got the case. Let's get back to dry ground. I prefer not to have a rusty nail driven through my foot right now, especially in this death trap. Nazer and I vacate the shit and return to the island. Here, I'm going to take a quick bathroom break, guys, so I'll be right back. I muted myself before I said I'd be right back, so I'll be right back. So apparently my stream deck shortcut doesn't work on my BRB anymore, so I gotta fix that after the stream's done, which is great. I'm wondering what other shortcuts aren't working. I'm hoping we can finish this one up soon, because I'm getting a little hungry. The shit is definitely a good name for the boat, thanks to Uncle Mo's creativity for names. Yes! Alright. Reed managed to grab one of the coolers that wasn't overturned, save for the fish inside. At least we'll have dinner. Hey, you got that radio? I root around to the emergency bag and pull it out. Here you go. Do you know how to work it? Yeah, Dad showed me when I was younger. I'll see if I can radio the ranger station. Sounds good. I'll see if Mo wants help. He dead. Hold on, wait. Hold on. No, I didn't want the whole chat out. There we go. I want to eat fish on that shit. How hungry? I'm pretty hungry. Nazer heads off to find a spot to get reception while I walk to the fire that Mo built. The Tyrannosaurus looks up and offers a smile. He's taken the fish we caught earlier and already got to work gutting and cooking them. Hey, Anon, how you feeling? Like shit. Well, the water broke my fall when I was ejected. I guess a bruised ego since I lost El Gigante. Now don't sweat the little things, kid. The fish don't matter none. The boat, though. He pokes at the fish on the spit as he very clearly tries to figure out what to say. I was already dented and scuffed all to hell. What's a couple more dings? Just an inconvenience. I sag and slump against a rock by the fire. You know, Anon, it's not my fault. Let me finish. If you really think you screwed up that badly, go talk to Rip about it. Don't let this sit and get worse. What would I say? He shrugs with his tiny arms and hands me a pair of spits. Asica parlare il tuo cuore. I don't know what that says. I don't know what it is. What? Mo slaps his chest. Let your heart speak. Speak from your mind. You want to figure out why he's giving you such a hard time? Ask him. Easier said than done. I realized that YouTube is now in top chat. I've probably, skipped some people's chats that were probably too spicy. I apologize. I leave with the fish that Mo offered as he waves me off. Before I can get far, I'm intercepted by Reed. Hey, Anon. How are you feeling? Shitty. Yeah. Listen, for what it's worth, thanks for bringing me along. Yeah, I'm glad at least you had fun. Reed gives me a nod. You want me to tag along with you while you go see Mr. Fang's dad? Honestly? Not the worst idea to have a witness to my impending murder. But on the other hand, maybe it's best to go one-on-one. I appreciate it, Reed, but I think this needs to be between me and him. There was no spicy there. I don't know. I have to, scroll up a bunch of, 100-some chats, probably. Reed nods and slows his gait, but calls out to me before I can get too far. Oh, by the way, Nazer told me to tell you that the park rangers can't get a boat out here till tomorrow. Looks like we're camping under the stars. Fuck, Mr. Aaron isn't gonna like that. Despite what the others have said, I can't help but feel like this is my fault. I haven't exactly tried to make a connection with Mr. Aaron. Even after the conversations I had with the others, I just brushed it off. I wish I could have left a better impression on him. But maybe it's not too late? Might as well be an adult about this and talk to him one-on-one. I follow the directions to the cave Mo told me about earlier. I'm quiet for a while, so no horny in a while. Good. You drink. I find Mr. Aaron sitting on a moss-covered boulder, gazing at the sunset. I hesitate a bit, but after taking a breath, I step into his view. Mr. Aaron? What do you want now, Anon? I figured we need to talk. This is only going to get worse if we sit on it. That being said, we won't be getting a rescue till tomorrow. I'm sorry that the boat crashed, and I didn't set the anchor after we made our last move. I'm not looking for forgiveness, but I think you should know that I'm not actively trying to get you to hate me. He sighs and runs a hand over his face. Look, Anon, I don't hate you. You just gotta understand that not everyone on the damn planet is out to get you, alright? Learn to accept help when it's offered. You fucked up big today and lost us not only the prized catch, but my boat as well. I don't even know if it's recoverable in the state she's in. And now we're stuck on this godforsaken island until tomorrow. He shakes his head and chucks a rock out into the water. Well, what more do you want from me? What do you want me to say? Mr. Aaron turned to me. His shadow blocked out the sun. Ooh, we get a special picture. Very nice. I'm gonna use that moment to drink. I just want to know who the hell you are. What are your motives? Not just with my daughter, but with everyone else. I don't understand you, Anon. You're one of the most awkward and inconspicuous kids I've ever met. And yet you somehow manage to sweep Lucy off her feet. He opens his beak to speak further, but nothing comes out. His jaw clicks shut as his gaze falls to the stone he had in his hand. I guess I should speak from my heart. I guess we just get along really well. I mean, neither of us had many friends. I went into Volcano High knowing nobody. Bang stuck to what? Two friends? We're both kind of antisocial, I guess. When we started spending more time together, we found out we had a lot in common. Same taste in shitty movies, same worldview. We're both into music, though in different ways, I guess. And deep down, I think we're both kind of lonely. When it comes to this trip, or you in general, you usually scare the shit out of me. Sure, that's all well and good, but like, how do I even connect with something like that? At any moment, I'm expecting a fist to come flying in at my face, but to my surprise, Mr. Aaron stays motionless. Okay, we went out with Dad, but when do we get to go out with Mother? Okay, you can make that mod then. I just want to stay on your better side. But it's hard to do when I don't know what's going to set you off. Do I tell the truth? Do I try to speak for myself? We're taking all this time to try and get a read on each other instead of just talking like normal people. Well, it's too late now. Sun's going down. Still gotta eat. What fish we have anyways? And tomorrow we leave. I reveal the kebabs Mo gave to me. Well, maybe we can talk a bit and eat. Mr. Aaron snags a kebab, but shakes his head. No, Anon. That ship has sailed. Wait, what? You heard me. After what had happened, now just isn't the right time. He sighs and looks up to the stars beginning to flicker across the sky. This was a mistake. I tried to force this. And I guess I let my paranoia and ego get the better of me. Zen, you are going to the prize room. I better not, otherwise my mod would definitely be on the government's list. Not an ending? Oh, I'll head back to the group. Is that where it's going to end? The rescue came the next morning. Sleeping on the beach sucked. One would expect it to be nice, temperate weather, starlit canopy, the gentle lapping of the lake. But the tension kept me from finding a decent sleep. Not to mention, I think I got sand in my shorts. The ride back was even worse. A stiff back on those car seats for an hour and a half, and relative silence. Almost no conversations were had, and whenever somebody tried to lighten the mood, the responses were short and quiet. Eventually, we made it back to the Aaron household. I unpacked quickly and made for the bus stop to go home. Anon! I flinch. I was hoping I could make a quick getaway. I really didn't want to disappoint Fang. Hey, Anon, is everything all right? No. Things didn't work out the way I was hoping. Yeah, this is the bad ending. And on Porku's mod list. What? I'm not making Zen a mod. Hell no. He's too thirsty. Fang giggles? Yeah, I heard Dad grumbling about it when he went inside. I can't believe he totaled the boat. Huh? He totaled the boat. That's what he said. It was technically my fault. I kind of figured it had something to do with you. He must have at least cared for you a little bit if he was willing to take the blame, though, right? I guess so. This is news to me. Thane pulls me into a hug. We still get to hug that taro. Bittersweet, but we fucked up, but not that bad. Ouch, my ego. You're fine, Zen. He doesn't show it, but he does like you. I can tell. A shame I keep fucking up, then. It'll take some time, but I know you two will make it work. She pulls away and gives me a reassuring smile, similar to the one she's given me before we left for the lake. I'm unfathomably lucky to have her. That's the end. Finally, back home. The apartment's just like as I left it. Maybe a bit untidy to rush to pack. The bed is lumpy and small, a far fetch from the bed at the cabin, even if I had to share it with Nazer. It's also quiet. And I don't mean from the outside noises. The sounds of chirping insects and croaking frogs have been replaced by screaming neighbors and crackhead babbling. I mean in a lonely sense. The last couple of nights were spent surrounded by friends and people I could at least partially trust. Now I'm alone again. Felt oddly empty. I felt oddly empty. Doesn't help that my conscience this weekend went pretty poorly either. I didn't exactly help the situation. Wait, he lied for... Oh, Ripley lied, yeah. Feels like I fucked up at every turn. For some reason, though. A reason I don't still fully understand. Mr. Aaron took the blame for the boat crash. Fang said it was because he cared about me. Someone make a mod starting from ending one. Do you really want that? Maybe. He does? He said before that he sees himself in me, that he doesn't hate me. We're kindred souls, but with completely opposite personalities. We grate on each other, despite having a lot in common. I just wish I could have figured that out sooner. If there was ever a trip up to the cabin, I feel like it's going to be a while before I'm invited back. Play through other endings for a special treat. Okay, so we're going to lie for Reed this time. I think that was part of the good part. Alright, skip. There's definitely meet up at Fang's house. I'll take the flashy thing. Stands out like a hooker on Skin Row, even the rusty bits. H-Man, yeah, same. Take the keys. I have zero idea what I'm doing. Ask for help. Find Nazer, because he never talks to us about that. Cover for Reed. Squirrel. Ask for help. Slap Reed's back. Speak your mind. Oh, this look. Yeah, this is probably the good ending because it stopped here. I yank and fight. With everyone's help, Nazer is able to scoop up the behemoth into the net and heave it back into the deck. The alabaster flops in defeat, and we all work to hold it down. Mr. Aaron reaches into its mouth and removes the hook. I heave him into my arms as best as I can. We all erupt into a wave of cheers. We did it! We freaking caught El Gigante! Good angling, punk! Nice work, Anon. Quick, let's get a picture of this gargant. Yeah, they really love their sound effects here. Alright. Reed reaches into his bag close by and reveals a disposable camera. Way ahead of you, bros. Say cheese! Uh-oh. At that moment of the flash, El Gigante thrashes in my arms. His tail fin angles for the perfect bitch slap across Mr. Aaron's beak. Ah, son of a... So it didn't hit me this time. Time seemed to slow as I watched him take an awkward step backwards. Mr. Aaron, watch out for the... Too late. He's back straight into the throttle. So he totals his boat this time. sending the boat lurching forward at mock speed. It's at this point I realize I forgot to set the anchor. The rest of us are knocked off balance and into a pile at the stern of the boat, but while having a white-knuckled grip at on the albino bastard. God, those are words. I am words. The rough waters made it difficult to regain our footing. The engine roars and the boat runs aground, pitching us all forward, catapulting us from our tangled positions. With a unified scream, we are all sent spiraling into the shallow waters. I barely have time to take a breath before I hit the water. Everything's quiet for a time as I claw my way up from beneath the surface. My lungs burn, but I soon burst from the deep like Free Willy. I gasp for breath as I wildly look around, only to find I was sitting in about a foot and a half water. I wish the main game had a way to date all the different main characters. Those are called mods. You want mods, buddy. We appear to have run aground on a small island in the center of the lake. The boat is on its side with a couple of feet of water. So is this all the same? No, it's not. To my relief, El Gigante was flung onto dry land where he flopped defeatedly. From somewhere behind me, I hear more splashing and sputtering. Alright, who's not dead? Sound off. Oh, my good wing. Woo, let's go again! I stand and shake the water out of my ears. I think I'm okay? Anon! Whoops, spoke too soon. Mr. Aaron storms over to me, anger clear across his beak. You unbelievably dense moron, you forgot to set the anchor, and now look at what happened. You couldn't even hold that fish properly. The trip is ruined, the boat is totaled, and we're stranded out on some island. Now hold on a sec, Rip, it was an honest mistake. They even have mods with Wani now? Really? I heard the first mod that they came out with was kind of a joke mod. Yeah, we all got caught up in the heat of the moment. We finally caught El Gigante. Anon ain't that bad, dude. Besides, Rip, you ain't the only one who... Ain't you the one who hit the throttle? Ripley looks as if he just swallowed a lemon. Why are you all vouching for him? He's been a bro, Mr. A. A good friend and a decent angler, I think. I can't believe this. The peeved Taro throws his hands up and walks further down the beach. It's really good how differens the routes are. I thought it was going to be a couple of different lines. Yeah, they're pretty different. I'm just going to wait for the Wani extras. We're all waiting, dude. One of you's got to get the emergency radio. Tell the park rangers we need to ride off this island. With that, Mr. Aaron sloshed through the shallows and stormed off. Hey, Anon, wanna help me check the boat for the radio? I guess, yeah. Not hyped for mods in general. Why aren't you hyped for mods? There could be some gold through there, you know. Sometimes mods can be good. The two of us head off for the capsized boat. The water was relatively shallow, and thankfully I wasn't wearing my sneakers, so I had no problem wading through it. Come on, let's go find the radio. Uncle Mo, start up a fire. I have a bad feeling we're going to be here for a while. I nod wordlessly as we slosh back over to the unturned boat. The shit holds true to their name, Anon. Even before. This, the boat was banged up and rusty. And I need to fucking... You know what? I'm going to take a drink and we'll come back. Rosa, Trish, Naomi mods are goat, though. The Trish mod was fucking bumpy. I don't know what the Trish mod was on, man. The way they just... Well, I'm not going to spoil the Trish mod, but... When the thing happens in Trish mod, it was so weird. It felt more like a joke than an actual mod. Give it a try. Not those who spin off the bad ends. A mod with a bonk dino if chat gets too horny. And just so you know, this wasn't your fault. Dad's just working through some emotions. He needs some time. Maybe I should go talk to him? I mean, that might work. It's crazy to think about, but you two really have hit it off these last couple of days. In an awkward and quiet sort of way, but it's a lot better than before. Well, I guess like Mo said, we have a lot more in common than we want to admit, even if it's not hobbies or friends and stuff. I hear Nazer chuckle from his crouched position. Looks like he's checking the half-open drawers and all their spilled contents. Floating in the water close by, I spot a disposable camera Reed had used to take the photo of El Gigante. A little wet, but it still works. Hey Nazer, look, it's the camera. Sweet, we still got evidence that we caught El Gigante then. Yeah, I also saw that he landed on the sand, so I think I saw Mo preparing a fire to cook him. Fucker deserves it all after all the hassle he's given us over the years. I hope he at least tastes good. He turns back to the clutter. Any signs of the box? Not yet. I reach above and root around in the closet. Bingo, I think. I pull a red box amidst the other spilled contents and pop it open. Sure enough, it's an emergency radio and some medical supplies neatly set in the container. Found it. Nice, let's get that radio booted up then. See if we can get a single... If we can't signal the park rangers. Maybe we'll meet Teddy. We'll meet Ted. The two of us take the box back to the beach. Mo already started up a bonfire, and on a makeshift spit is El Gigante. He smells good. Hey, you punks, you find the radio? Yeah, we did. I'll get it started up. Dad taught me how to work this thing a while back. While Nazer takes care of that, I sit at the fire with Mo. It doesn't take long before I'm dragged into another conversation. Not that I mind. So, I overheard you talking to Nazer out there. He's gonna talk to Rip? I hope so, yeah, if he's willing to listen. You know what you're doing. You'll be fine. He's angry at himself. He doesn't know how to talk to you, and it's frustrating him. Am I going to get a pep talk from everyone before I actually get to talk the chance to talk to Mr. Aaron? Where's Reed? But just be patient. Give him a heart-to-heart. If you can show him that you trust him with the deep stuff, he'll reciprocate that. I guess opening up wouldn't be the worst. That's the spirit. And just remember, Anon, at the end of the day, it's not about fishing. It ain't even about bonding or the problems we have and the struggles we face. It's not. Of course not. It's about the Mets, baby. Gotta love the Mets. Come on, hit a home run, baby. Gotta love those Mets, baby. It's our year, baby. The Mets are gonna win, baby. I just know it. We just love these memes, man. We love these overused memes. I turn to leave, but Mo stops me. Don't go empty-handed. Mo takes the smoky carcass of El Gigante off the flames and begins to cut into his crispy flesh. Take some Gigante kebabs with you, huh? I found some wild oregano and a bit inland. He's pretty damn tasty. Oh, Uncle Mo. I grab one and take a cautious bite, only to be pleasantly surprised. Even with minimal equipment, Mo manages to cook incredibly well. I take a few more sticks that were ready and head off to where I last saw Mr. Aaron heading. It's a lot harder to find Mr. Aaron than I thought. I saw him heading into the rocks over there, but I can't seem to find him. Hey, bro. And there's Reed. Let's see what his two cents are. What's up, Reed? Come to reassure me? Nah, man, I just thought I'd see how you're holding up, you know? Okay, I guess. I was on my way to talk to Mr. Aaron, but I can't find him. There's a grotto in the far side of the island. I think he went that way. Let him cook. So far, I saw one mod for I Want to Hug That Gator. I could be wrong if there are more. I haven't even seen any mods. Thanks. No prob, dude. It was a short conversation, but it looks like he wants to say something more, but decides against it. You think I'm making the right call? Going and talking to him? Oh, totally. He comes off as a hard ass, but the longer you're around, the more he warms up. Could be different for you, considering you're, the romance between you and Fang, but I mean, he gave me the same stink the first time I swung by. I want to fix that gator. Oh yeah, wasn't it a mod off of Ending 1 or something? I knew I never thought of Fang that way, but he was always protective. You think that's why he's always so on edge? Totes my goats, bro. Doubt he'd ever tell you that to your face, though. I want to marry that gator. Well, that's the super ending. We propose, but we don't get the wedding picture. But who knows? You two have really connected it this week. Could be wrong. If I am, I owe you a spliff. Sure, Reed. I think I can say for everyone, thank you, Porcupine. You've done a lot for this community. I've only popped up on the radar like 2 weeks ago. That's crazy. Anyways, I won't keep you from your fate any longer. Reed offers me the double finger guns. Good luck, man. You got this. After the brief insight from Reed, I head off to the cave he pointed out. It wasn't so much a cave rather than a small opening in the rocks. No wider than a sewer outlet. I could probably squeeze in if I crouched. Not that I would. I'd love a mod with a wheelchair Anon to see his life from that perspective, though tasteful. If the extras have a future chapter like Snoot Game and we get to see the wedding, I'm a legit cry. I getcha. I mean, I don't know if I'd have to like replay the game to get those extras, or if they're just gonna be like put in because the game knows you played those endings. I mean, I don't want to do all the legwork again, you know. Mr. Aaron was perched on a rock close by. I could see his eyes dart between me and the lake. What? Figured I'd come by and offer you some dinner. Gigante kebabs a la mo. I take a cautious seat next to the man. Man, I can't talk. He gingerly accepts the fish and takes a bite. Not too bad. You did a good job on him. Did you find the radio and get it working? Yeah, we can expect a pickup tomorrow morning at the earliest. I don't like it falling to silence like this, but it's abundantly clear that neither of us want to address the elephant in the room. I made progress with Mr. Aaron this weekend, but it feels as if there's still barriers left to be brought down. Honestly, after watching Iwani hug that gator, I was sad that it ended, but looked more to watch and found Snoot Game, and after this, now I want more. Yeah, we always want more. We're always hungry and we're always eating. Bro can't perform noises through his vocal cords. Well, we're 3 hours and a half in. My voice is probably calling it, but we're going to see this through. We're going to try our best. Just bear with me. After everything I've learned about him, though, I don't blame him for wanting to leave them up. Raptor Jesus knows I would have done the same. I have a feeling he can hear at least part of this, too. Bits and pieces, but you're getting better at keeping it in your head. Yeah. The tarot takes an audible breath. I miss so much Idikin. Yeah, we all miss Idikin. Maybe there'll be an Idikin mod. I'm sorry. We get a new picture. It wasn't fair of me to blow up at you like that. In truth, we gotten along really well. Come on, you did this for 7 hours. Surely you can be dumb enough to do it again. We're not going 7 hours. I'm dying. I'm hungry. And I need to eat before quiet hours. I like that. Getting along with you, I mean. I do too. You can be really scary, though. Mr. Aaron snorts a chuckle. That's done on purpose, but I think you know that. Yeah. Listen, son. Yes, sir. I'm protective. You're the first boyfriend Lucy's had. As a father, you never want to see your daughter carried off by a stranger. I want what's best for her, even if she hates me for it. I wanted that gator and Snoot Game. Hopefully the community will make more content for those two. Yeah, who made this? I forget who made this mod. It's mentioned in Snoot Club. It's part of the reason I brought you out here, Anon. I wanted to know who you are as a person, what kind of emotions existed below that beige mask you hide behind. What's quiet hours? I live in an apartment, dude. There's quiet hours at a certain point. Hunger is for the weak. I am weak. This is new territory for me. I've never had to do any of this before. I'm scared, Anon. I'm scared you'll break her heart. I'm scared she'll resent me for whatever reason more than she already does. I can't do anything but watch it play out. It's like I'm helpless as this all unfolds. It's frustrating. All this hostility ends up on your shoulders. Mr. Earn sighs. I can see his shoulders and wings sag. He has a tired look in his eyes, a tired that sleep can't fix, a tired I know very well. What face? His face is the mask. There's already an Iwani mod to play for Snoot, but I don't recommend it. You're a good kid, Anon. I can see with that. I'm just trying to be a good dad. I really wish my parents cared about me like you care about Fang. From my periphery, I can see Ripley turn his head towards me. It's like the moment I turned 18, they started looking for any excuse they could to kick me out. Even before that, the last time I remember my mom worrying over me was when I was like 12 or 13. My dad, though, he was always trying to send me off somewhere. I don't know if it was character building like he claimed or something else. I felt like they didn't care. I started keeping to myself in my room. I pissed away so much time staring at my monitor, hoping I could just fly under the radar another day. I guess Dad found the excuses he needed. Next thing you know, I'm here. And then I met Fang. If it was a mask, it would be green. Everything changed after that. She helped you be less reclusive. I suppose, in a way, we helped each other out. I started feeling empathetic. Granted, a part of it did come from Spears, but with Fang. I don't know, it's like I want to be a better person. Then there's the argument she has with you. Are the things you've said to me. But although it's terrifying and unnerving, seeing the things you do and the stuff you say, it shows you really are a caring father. For what it's worth, I'm sorry too. I'm just not the best at discussing my past. I'm used to being ridiculed for it. I didn't know how bad you had it, or how long for that matter. I shouldn't have added to your suffering like I did. Gotta admit, I like the chill moment between these two. Yeah, it's pretty good. It's nothing I haven't had to deal with before. Maybe not in the same way, but same idea. Too bad there's not enough time to start over. It would have made this trip a fair bit better. What about the rest of the tonight? What do you mean? Mo built a bonfire. Mazer and Reed are over there, too. Wanna head back with me? Mr. Earn is quiet for a long time. I can see a genuine smile spread across his beak. You know what? Sure, that sounds like a good idea. This mod is good. I will mod's a chance, except Trish mod. I dislike Trish in ending one. Yeah, the Trish mod is kind of low quality, in my opinion. He gives me a hearty pat on the back. This time not as hard. I barely can see Trish again or Naomi. The two of us head back to the bonfire and are greeted by the others. We spend the rest of the night chatting about past vacations and other wild stories we had. You know what it is with messing me up? I'm gonna blame the sound effects, guys. I don't feel as hesitant to open up about my past now. We enjoy the last of the Gigante kebabs and take a few more pictures with the disposable camera before turning in and sleeping out under the stars on the beach. Low quality, that's just Rule 34 novel, nothing more. Morning comes, and with it, rescue from the island. We spend our last few hours collecting our things from the cabin and packing up. Reed bids us farewell and drives off before we leave. The car ride back is jovial and full of unending conversations. Topics of great many things, from fishing stories all the way to corny jokes at Mr. Aaron's expense. I find myself wishing that we could have had at least a couple more hours together. While we may have not caught much, we managed to wrangle in the legendary El Gigante, a tale that will be told for years to come. Countryside melds to urban sprawls quicker than I wanted, and before long, we find ourselves back in Volcadera. Fang is waiting for me in the driveway when we pull up. I can barely unload my things when she envelops me in a hug. How'd it go, dweeb? Surprisingly well, actually. We managed to catch the huge legendary fish, and I even got along with your dad. In fact, the more I think about it, the more I'm pretty sure I had a heart-to-heart with everyone on that trip at some point. Raptor Jesus, I don't even want to see number 34 now. Yeah, that separates the trash people from the regular Snoot Bros. That's great. Means I don't have to go anymore. I don't know, Fang. You don't know what you're missing. We had a blast. We sure did. My god, these fucking sound effects, dude. I very nearly jump into Fang's arms. How the hell does he sneak around like that without me knowing? You did good this weekend, son. I'm proud of you. Really? Damn, Anon. I hope you plan on coming to the next one. Once we get the boat repaired, that is. You'd have me again? In a heartbeat. Despite our losses, I'd be lying if I said it wasn't the most fun I've had on a fishing trip in a long while. I want to see the wholesome mods more. I still can't get over the fact that they made Jesus a furry in this universe, Raptor Jesus. I think I'm starting to see why Lucy likes you. He gives a final pat on my shoulder and heads off with his luggage. Oh, how about that? I'm impressed. You made more progress with my old man than I've made in the last 2 years. I'm surprised on how well we work together when we aren't being awkward or standoffish. Fang smiles and gives me a kiss on the cheek. Want to hang out for a bit before you take off? You can work on our song. Sure, I could tell you all about the boat crash. The one I totally had no part in. At least they made Jesus a raptor. Can't complain because it's a meme. The apartment I call home is oddly silent. And I don't mean in the normal sense. But the sound of car alarms and screaming crackheads is always a constant on Skid Row. I mean in the sense of company. These last few days I've been spoiled in talking into the early hours of the morning with others. Actual face-to-face conversations, not arguments through a computer screen. Genuine connection. It's an odd shift back into the life of my little hovel. This weekend has been nuts. The boat crash, El Gigante, all those bonding moments with the guys, waking up cuddling Nazer. I'm erasing that last one from my memories. In any case, it was a foreign experience, yet I feel I've grown closer with all involved. Not to mention bonding with Ripley. As scary as he is, everyone was right. We have a lot in common. That trip could have gone much worse, but we acknowledged our problems and talked it out before it got too bad. I never took the time to think about things from his perspective, be it his relationship with Fang or me. I learned that beneath his tough exterior lies a truly caring man. A man who is just as scared and cautious of the unknown as me. Who would have thought that we could have actually get along? In any case, all good things must come to an end. It's not the worst, though. I know I'll be back. With all my friends and family. Rosa is wholesome mod. Naomi mod is constructive. I would say it's like a character act, totally different slowly. Thank you for playing. Is this the bonus? A little picture? Thank you for playing. Is that it? That was just a picture. That was the bonus? It's just a picture we pretty much saw before? Are you kidding me? I will start saving screenshots of Fang's hugs. I love them. Wow. I mean, it's a good mod, but I've got to criticize that. The ending, the bonus feels like I got the short end of the deal. Damn it. Yeah. I mean, all in all, good mod. Good mod. It held my attention. All the endings were really good. No, yeah, all the endings were good. I mean, what would you expect? You can't have, like, anything bad, like, truly bad happening. Did you do Trish mod? I watched Smug Fox's playthrough of Trish mod. And I'll probably throw up the end. Well, no, we don't have to put on the ending screen. We can chat for a bit. And I can go eat. And stretch out. Be less sweaty. Let me check Discord real quick. Pull that over. Because I got people messaging me. Trish mod is lewd in that, and just that it has that wholesome ending, but I saw some of the Trish mod endings. Some of them, well, one of them, well, I don't know, I can't really remember all of it off of my head because I'd like to forget Trish mod, to be honest. Fun mom? Are you talking about Samantha? Fun mom. Samantha is a fun mom. Good stream in the Discord. It's not even over yet. But it might be, because I want to go eat. I see people are heading their way out. And that's fair. We're just wrapping up. And I am really hungry, so... Yeah, where's the mod with Samantha? Where's the Samantha mod? We need it. Trish mod is a weird one. You know the Samantha mod's gonna be lewd as hell. That's gonna be a sketchy one to stream on YouTube. Trish mod is a weird one. It is. Go eat, man. Yeah, I do need to eat. Maybe I'll come back later tonight and we'll play... Well, either not tonight, but definitely tomorrow we'll play Morgan's Skate Club. Because I know I promised that today, but then I had to move this stream to today from yesterday to hang out with a friend of mine. So, yeah. I'll probably wrap it up. Good stream, Porku, yeah. I made it through. Discord for lewd ones? Maybe. Maybe. Maybe we'll do a Discord exclusive. Who knows? You are my favorite. But those are some touching words. I'd never expect to be people's favorites. Don't say you won't play because you know you will. I'll probably play this. If there's a Samantha mod, I will probably play it either at Discord or in private. Great stream. It was a great stream. Thanks to everyone who was here. I didn't expect to like have the Wani people like be here too, because going from Wani to Snoot, we didn't hit 100, but we did hit like near 70. So I'm happy. You guys are good. We'll see you later. While I go eat. Have a good night.